U.S. Senator James Inhofe has apologized after he used photos from 2008 to promote the idea that Russian troops are invading Ukraine. Speaking on the Senate floor, the Oklahoma Republican presented exclusive photographs he said were evidence of Russian troops and tanks crossing into eastern Ukraine. However, the Washington Beacon and other websites quickly proved the photos were of Russian troops driving near Russia's border with Georgia in 2008. Inhofe released a statement saying he was furious to learn one of the photos provided now appears to be falsified from an AP photo taken in 2008. The senator stated there was still plenty of evidence indicating Russia is advancing into Ukraine with tanks. He has been a vocal supporter of arming Ukraine to fight against Russia. As of last week, 11 members of Congress have co-sponsored a resolution calling for the declassification of 28 pages of the 2002 Congressional 9/11 report. The resolution was introduced by North Carolina Republican Representative Walter Jones. Two varieties of genetically engineered apple have been approved by the U.S. Department of Agriculture. The USDA's Animal and Plant Health Inspection Service approved Onagonkan Specialty Fruits genetically engineered apples designed to resist bruising and browning after being sliced. APHIS said the tree does not pose an agricultural or environmental threat. The agency approved Onagonkan's Arctic Golden and Arctic Granny apples. The Liberty Beat is sponsored in part by the Free State Project. Want to find liberty in your lifetime? Then join thousands of others who are making the move to New Hampshire, the freest state in the Union. To learn more or to pledge to move today, visit freestateproject.org. Support also comes from the Conscious Resistance Network. Videos, news reports, and articles from a spiritual anarchist perspective. Experience the Conscious Resistance at theconsciousresistance.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Monday, February 16th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
A total loser's corpse contained no traces of drugs or alcohol, and a superstitious Delta Airlines adds busty mermaids to its plane noses. My friend, you look like you are in need of the world's finest internet news summaries. Please come in and warm yourself by the fire of knowledge. This is the Onion Week in Review. A new law passed in Colorado this week will allow residents with a doctor's prescription to purchase medicinal fireworks, saying that those in need of stargazers, firecrackers, and Galleria highlights now need only obtain a doctor's prescription. State officials expressed hope that the law would ease the suffering of those in need of huge, dazzling explosions. And in this week's op-ed pages, a man notes that, like it or not, we all die, then get dug up and molested. In other news, white male privilege is squandered on a job at Best Buy, and a local TCBY has missed the past two logo changes. Well, that's it for now. Goodbyes are bittersweet, my love, so I'll only tell you, for more, keep checking theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you'd like here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com and please enjoy the features there. You can create the content. Whatever you see there on the front page was put there by listeners like you and then voted on either up or down, whether you like or dislike. You can kind of help us decide what to talk about. Of course, the best way to get what you want on the air is to call in toll-free or via Skype. You can Skype in at username lrn.fm, and you can call toll-free at 855-450-FREE. With you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Derek J.
And Mark.
All right. So, Derek J., you and I had the exact same story to discuss here tonight. And honestly, I haven't taken the time to reach out to the victim in this particular case. He's a listener and supporter of Free Talk Live. We've had him on the phone before. Virgil Viduva is his name, and he is really stirring it up there in Greene County, Ohio, where the story here I've got from, I don't know where yours is from, this one's from countercurrentnews.com. On Sunday, Dayton, Ohio, police officer Paul Harris threatened a Greene County Herald journalist with arrest. Reporter Virgil Viduva has, in fact, been arrested while in the course of reporting and taking photographs, but this would be the first time he was threatened with arrest for debating an off-duty police officer on Facebook. The whole thing started after the Greene County Herald posted several videos related to protests against the city of Xenia's anti-panhandling ordinance. We ran some of these videos, too, and talked to Viduva about his activism outside of his work with the local news source. The city of Xenia, Ohio, has banned being poor and asking for money within township limits. Now activists like Virgil have changed the game with civil disobedience what they call panhandling protests, where they donate the money collected to charity. They've given the city 3 months to scrap the law or face a federal lawsuit.
They're going to lose, and they're going to lose bad. The fact is,
who's going to lose? The city?
The city. Yeah, the state of Florida has already lost on this one. Mm-hmm. You can panhandle. It's freedom of speech. You can hold a sign asking for money. It's, you know, I'm not a fan of people walking up to me and asking for money. I'm not here defending this behavior, but that's just the end of the story. Is in a free society where people have the freedom of speech, you need to have the guts to say, no, thank you. I prefer not to give this way.
Well, I agree with that. But also, this is kind of part and parcel of having the idea of public property as well, right? So if I have if I've got like a shopping mall or a strip mall or something like that, where I've got businesses who are paying rent to be there, and then there's some old hobo, excuse me, Derek, you're the homo. there's some old hobo, some wino sitting out in front of my business looking trashy and smelling up the place and, you know, pestering people to get money, then I should be fully within my rights to tell that guy to take off. But what you're describing, Mark, is something that should be legal in places that are considered public, wherein, you know, if it's government-owned property, a road
right.
or a
sidewalk. They'll say it all the time. Well, this property is owned by everybody. Well, if it's owned by everybody, then somebody can stand out here with a sign and ask for money.
But, Mark, what about going to the next level where somebody might stand out there and sell bottles of water without a vendor's license? Are you saying that should be allowed?
I think that it gets into some difficulties, but that's really the problem with public property, right?
Well, the fact that if anybody can use it for whatever purpose, then in theory it could be overrun by a bunch of itinerant vendors.
Yeah, I'd prefer it to be overrun by vendors, frankly. I mean, the homeless people I saw in Philadelphia who sold things were my favorite kind because
sure.
you know, they've actually got some value to exchange with you instead
They're doing
of just
something
begging.
Useful.
Yeah.
No, I totally agree, and it doesn't bother me either. In fact, I love the idea of seeing some civil disobedience in this particular area, and there has been some of that. It would be nice to see more of it. Obviously, we're in the wintertime here in New Hampshire, and it's pretty hard to get people to go out and do outside sales at this time of year, but there was once upon a time when we did have this flea market event that a former co-host of ours put together, and the police came out there in force that morning to prevent anyone from even setting up. They got wind that this was going to happen, and they went out there and they literally threatened a little girl. I think she was 7 years old, an early mover for the Free State Project, Amanda Bolden, who's actually now a state representative here. She had brought her daughter out with essentially a freezer full of ice cream.
Was it?
Like a chest freezer, like a full. They took a truck out here from Manchester with a chest freezer full of ice cream, and also they had limeade that they were prepared to sell at this what was supposed to be kind of this open air flea market taking place at a public park here in Keene. And the police were out there with as many cops as they had on duty that morning, like five cops, to put a stop to this. They threatened that little girl over trying to sell some limeade.
That is so disgusting. I mean, what possibly could the cops think that they're doing right in that situation? Like, all right, guys, here's a scoop. There's going to be some people with ice cream, and we better shut them down. I mean, really? Why didn't some cop say, nah, let's not do this? We have discretion, right? So let's just not go there.
Well, and it's also inconsistent because they've used their discretion in other instances. So we used to do an event called Free Keene Fest, which has kind of morphed over the years into Keenevention. But it used to be a kind of a bi-yearly gathering that would happen in one of the local parks, Railroad Square here in Keene. And people would set up booths and they would sell stuff. Some people were selling food without a permit. Other people were selling T-shirts or whatever it is that they brought to Ben. So it's not to say it hasn't happened. And you know, the time when it was cracked down upon, I feel like Free Keene Fest had already happened a few times at that point. So I don't know what made them crack down on the flea market but left Free Keene Fest alone. It's very strange. You can't.
Nor do I.
Yeah, there's no consistency here. So back to Virgil and their protests, where they're doing panhandling protests. The city of Xenia has banned that. In 2013, they passed an ordinance which essentially prohibited poor people from asking for any form of assistance. In response, three local activists crashed a Xenia City Council meeting to demand the law be scrapped. Viduva was one of them. He told the city council that the city has 3 months to ditch this illegal and unconstitutional law, otherwise they'll be slapped with a federal lawsuit. In the meantime, Virgil volunteered to commit a fourth-degree misdemeanor in order to raise money for a local charity and demonstrate the absurdity of the ordinance, which he explains, quote, criminalizes speech and the act of verbalizing questions to another human being in a public space.
And I was curious, so I looked this up. A fourth-degree misdemeanor in Ohio is up to 30 days in jail. It's the lowest amount that you can serve jail time. So
yeah, I'm really surprised, though.
Yeah, the only thing lower is a minor misdemeanor, which has no jail sentence.
However, once a Dayton cop started trolling the Greene County Herald Facebook page, which had posted the video of Virgil's testimony to the city council, Virgil couldn't help but step in at the request of his employer. You can find the brief exchange screen captured below, which I will read to you here. Do you happen to have it pulled up there, Derek J? If so, we can play characters on this.
I don't have the same article. In fact, I was reading this from a different article. But
interesting. So I've got the screen capture here. The officer's name is Paul Harris.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I see that screen cap. It's also posted on the article I'm reading.
Do you want to be the cop, or should I be, or do you want to be Virgil?
Yeah, I'll be the cop.
Okay,
go ahead.
The
problem
first.
With the majority of panhandlers is they're walking in traffic up to your vehicle and start a disturbance when they get nothing. Then the panhandler wants to complain because the mother with her newborn baby drove off and hit him with the car when he or she refused to leave the mother alone.
So Virgil's responding as Greene County Herald, as that page name on Facebook. He writes, there are already laws against what you described. It's called harassment and assault.
To arrest someone for harassment or assault, you first need a complaint. Most people call the police for a panhandler, but do not stay or want contacted by the police.
Whoa. Before you go on, why would that be? Why would people not actually want to talk to the police when they're reporting a crime?
Because they are afraid that they might be charged with a crime or they might be doing something wrong.
They might just be busy and the panhandler's already wasting their time.
That's true. Yeah. And the police are going to waste more of their time. But also, I think that Derek J's concern is valid.
I've got some pot on me, so I'd rather not talk to this cop.
There could be that, and it's not uncommon for the police to show up somewhere on the behest of someone who called them and then put the person who called them in handcuffs to find some sort of excuse just to put someone. The panhandler's already left the scene, so, let's arrest the guy who called.
Yeah, the thing is, everything is criminalized in modern America, so you could always be committing some crime that you don't even know about,
right.
And the cop is going to find out once they're talking to you. So I want to be clear also that I read the typo by the cop. So I'm continuing to read his typos.
All right.
As we go.
We'll come back with the rest of the interaction here. We've yet to get to the actual threat. That's coming up. 855 450-FREE. You've got a cop just openly threatening one of our listeners and independent newsman, photojournalist, Virgil Viduva. More on the way here at 855 450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
For deals on the latest hardwood flooring trends, get to Lumber Liquidators. Don't settle for the stuff at the big box stores. We've got all the hottest flooring styles for less, like the timeless look of real oak. This week, get pre-finished oak hardwood for less than you'd pay for laminate at other stores. Now, it's an incredible 99 cents. Or get 3/4 inch solid pre-finished red oak for $2.59. Plus, it's your last chance to save $500 on Bellawood. Get deals on bamboo, laminates, and more from 49 cents. And special financing. Don't miss this season's hottest hardwood deals. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
A congressman recently revealed that legislation totaling 2,900 pages and involving more than $1 trillion was available to members of Congress for less than 48 hours to study and consider. That's over 60 pages of legislation per hour. Do you think anyone read the entire bill? I'm Jim Babka with DownsizeDC.org. Consider a proposal buried in a 3,200-page, $388 billion bill, which would have empowered committee chairmen or their agents to examine Americans' tax returns. When this horrible provision came to light, no one claimed to know how it got into the bill. One congressman questioned said, "I didn't write it, I didn't approve it, I wasn't even consulted." If your attorney represented you this way, he might be disbarred. But this is how Congress represents you every day. That's why DownsizeDC.org has created the Read the Bills Act. You can force Congress to read their bills before they pass them at DownsizeDC.org.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. Take control of the airwaves. Bring up whatever's on your mind. And you can also join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. So feel free to reach out that way if you don't mind. You will tend to sound better if you call on Skype. But it's not a requirement. We've also got the toll-free lines, 855-450-FREE. Virgil Viduva, one of our listeners and supporters, also an independent journalist and photojournalist, there in the Greene County Herald, is in a situation, a conflict with a police officer in a series of Facebook posts where police officer Paul Harris, while apparently he was not on duty, but as far as I'm concerned, you're always a police officer whether or not you're on duty, because certainly an off-duty cop can make an arrest too. This guy's insulting and threatening towards Virgil. We'll give you more of that here in a moment. Also, how to get a pound of some of the best coffee out there from BuzzBox. It's easy. You go to coffee.freetalklive.com and you can get signed up there. You just pay the shipping cost. That pound will be shipped directly to your location, and you can enjoy the hell out of this coffee. It's really great. I mean, it's 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica, shade-grown coffee. BuzzBox is some of the best coffee you can buy, but also a portion of the profits from every pound goes towards microloans that we are teaming up with Kiva.org and BuzzBox to loan out money to folks in tough parts of the world, help them make a better living for themselves. So you can help that out by joining the program over at coffee.freetalklive.com. Now, you can cancel anytime. It's a subscription program, so you'll automatically receive more coffee every so often. You decide how often you receive it. You decide how much you receive. You decide the flavor. You customize everything.
Yeah. If, for instance, you have coffee left over and you know they'll give you an email a week before your coffee's ready to be roasted and stuff. Yeah. And this is what happened. Because I was away on vacation for some time, I did take BuzzBox with me, but, you know, I just got some more left over. So I bumped it back a couple of weeks.
That's always nice. That way you're not building up too much product.
Yeah.
You can customize it to your tastes and consumption habits. So, coffee.freetalklive.com. You go there, get your first pound free. Just pay the shipping cost. Coffee.freetalklive.com. Virgil is with us in Ohio here, and we are reenacting, Virgil, your Facebook conversation here that you had as Greene County Herald. You were acting as that particular Facebook page at the time, as cited over by Countercurrent News. So we'll keep you on the line here as Derek Jay and I continue the reenactment. Derek, we were in the midst of Paul Harris, the police officer from the Xenia, was it Xenia County? Is that right? Or Xenia?
Xenia's a city.
It's a town.
Yeah, and
town of Xenia.
And remember, I am also reading his typos, so here we go, because he has many. To arrest someone for harassment or assault, you first need a complaint. Most people call the police for a panhandler but do not stay or want contacted by the police. The caller in just wants the panhandler to leave people alone and leave. All the police have to do is watch the violator as he or she can be charged with panhandling.
Virgil responds, there's no leaving people alone on a public street. If you don't want people to say hello to you and may I have a few dollars on the street, then don't talk to them.
I'll see you in Dayton and give you your second M4 arrest. I hope $40 is worth the trip to jail.
Now, let me break. We've got Virgil here on the line. What is he referring to with the $40? You know, asking.
So there's a backdrop to this. There's a context to this story. On Friday, which is what, 3 days ago or so, I went and purposefully violated a City of Xenia ordinance by panhandling right in front of the city hall and in front of the police department.
Nice.
They're all in the same. They're all in the same building. I was not aware until last week that panhandling was actually illegal in the City of Xenia. Mm-hmm. And the reason I became aware is because I heard over the scanner on Thursday about this woman. She was just released from jail recently. And then I hear this police call, you know, someone called the cops on her because she asked someone for help. And here's this woman. She gets out of jail. She has nothing. No phone, no cash, no ride, nobody to help her. She makes the mistake of asking someone for help. So what do the cops do? They show up and start threatening her with arrest. So fortunately, I was able to get there in time and give her a ride to a bus stop in Dayton, you know, which is a fairly good drive. It's like a 15, 20-minute drive.
Okay.
I didn't want this person to go to jail again, you know. So that really upset me. And we ended up, you know, a handful of us showed up to the city council meeting on Thursday night. You know, we have it all on video. And then Friday I said, you know what, I'm going to do some civil disobedience today. So let's do some panhandling. So I spent about an hour and a half in front of the city hall. Asking people for money. I had, you know, a little secret camera wired to my cardboard sign, you know, which was all kind of beat up. I tried to make it, you know, a little bit homeless type of sign, you know, whatever that means. But so I raised about $41.98.
How long did that take to raise?
About an hour and a half.
Now, did you tell the people that you were raising money for charity, or were you just?
Yes, I was very open about when people asked, I told them. When they did not ask, I did not tell them. I simply asked mostly, do you have a couple of bucks to spare?
Let me ask you about the clothes you wore, because this fascinates me. I wonder what kind of money these folks make doing the jobs they do. Did you shave?
I shaved a couple of weeks ago. So, yes, I did not have a beard. I was, like, really bundled up because it was so cold outside.
Yeah.
But I was fairly clean. I did not necessarily make an effort to look homeless or anything.
Okay. I was just wondering if, you know, what it might be like.
But by definition, you were panhandling. I haven't pulled up the statute or ordinance or whatever.
Absolutely.
Yeah. But, okay. So they could have arrested you for this.
Oh, yeah. This is actually a fourth-degree misdemeanor in Ohio. This can carry a 30-day jail sentence.
And you got video of yourself doing the panhandling as well. Has that been released?
Yep. All the video is on the Greene County Herald page on Facebook and also on greenherald.com.
So then in theory, they could arrest you for panhandling any time, right? Because the video is online. Even if the cops didn't witness you doing it, you took video of yourself doing it, and so they could use that video and you know, get a warrant for your arrest based on that.
But that's not the end of the story. The cops actually came out. They warned me. They asked me to move along, and I told them I will not. I informed them very kindly that this is an unconstitutional ordinance, that I asked them what would happen, and they said I would get cited. And I said, well, if you guys cite me, I said that will give me standing in a potential federal lawsuit against the city. And I asked him, I said, in fact, please give me a ticket so I can, you know, move on. and they did. They did. After
they
about
did
an
ticket
hour
you? Kind of them. Yeah, that's a kind of them.
Yes, yes.
Oh,
they
I didn't realize
give me a
that.
Ticket.
Okay.
They charged me with a fourth-degree misdemeanor, and I have a hearing in court on Wednesday, which is, what, in 2 days?
So then just to clarify something, the police officer here, Paul Harris, who's threatening you openly on Facebook, saying he's going to give you your second M4, that's your second fourth-degree
right.
misdemeanor, meaning that he would arrest you for panhandling again?
I assume that's what he meant. You know, he's not a cop in Xenia. He's a cop in Dayton, which is about 10, 15 minutes away or so.
I see.
So I'm not sure what, but that is a very clear threat, you know, to me on Facebook, you know, especially his breathe easy, you know, statement at the end there.
Virgil, what do you say to, and I want to talk more about this and what your plan is in court and all that, but what do you say to the people who would claim, well, what's with you libertarian civil disobedience? Why don't you do anything that's useful? Here you are standing up for homeless people. Don't you, you know, can't you stand up for genocide or something important like that? I'd like to have you answer that question when we come back. There's more here in moments.
Absolutely.
You can stick with us, right? All right, cool. More with Virgil Vaduva here from the Greene County Herald in Ohio, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. It's Free Talk Live.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and sling bows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Good people need help. The Homeowners Association said we had weeds and fined us $25. We told them they had the wrong house. They said if we didn't pay it, they'd file a lien. Our attorney demanded photographs, witnesses, and told them if they couldn't provide this, they must cease and desist. Issue solved. Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Every day you make investment decisions. When you do business with and hold U.S. dollars, you make an investment in the soundness of the moral philosophy and the potential longevity of the United States hegemony. People who claim a monopoly on violence around the world. If this is the investment that you want to make, please keep listening to LRN.FM. If not, stop using their currency. Use bitcoins. Get educated. WeUseCoins.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's
the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you may dial toll-free to bring up anything you want at 855-450-FREE. The town of Xenia, Ohio, or I guess it's a city, is population 26,000 people. That's where Virgil Viduva, one of our listeners who is on the line with us here.
And an amplifier.
Yeah, that's right, a supporter of Free Talk Live. He actually donated that fancy camera that we don't use often enough these days.
We probably need to.
Yeah. So anyway, so we've got him on the line. He was threatened by a police officer the other day openly on Facebook, and we actually haven't quite finished recounting that particular threatening conversation. We will do that here. But we were talking with Virgil about his protest where he was engaging in the textbook definition of panhandling, asking people for money on the streets, specifically out in front of City Hall in Xenia. And we'll continue with that discussion here with Virgil in moments. But want to let you know about Vegas.com. They serve up Vegas from the inside over at Vegas.com because unlike other travel sites, and there are a billion of them, they are from Vegas. Everyone at Vegas.com lives in Vegas. They work in Vegas and they party in Vegas. They know the people that set the deals, and once the prices drop in Vegas, Vegas.com drops them on their site in real time. They offer the best rates on not just hotels, but also headliner shows, tours, attractions, and even VIP bottle service at top clubs. You go to Vegas.com, surf around, check out the huge selection, the best prices you'll find, and you get even better prices with code FTL. You get 10% off of everything on the site, excluding air hotel packages. So if it's got air involved, you can't get the 10%. But otherwise, use code FTL over at Vegas.com and don't miss their proprietary drop watch feature, which will actually allow you the lowest rates on hotels, where they'll continue to monitor the price even after you book, and they'll notify you of the changes to ensure you get the best deal. You book at the lower rate, and they'll refund you the difference. Vegas.com does the work for you, and they've got your back. Vegas.com, code is FTL. Punch that in at your checkout to get that extra 10% off. As we go back to Virgil in Ohio. So, Virgil, some people are going to look at this, and they're going to say, you know, you're not any different from those activists in Keene, New Hampshire. You're picking the most unimportant issues to focus on, Virgil, trying to help homeless people panhandle and bother other people. Why can't you focus on something important like healthcare?
Well, this is a twofold argument, right? The first issue is that it's very personal to me, right? I grew up in Romania. I grew up in a house with a dirt floor, literally a dirt floor. The floor in the house was the dirt from, you know, the ground, the actual ground. There were times when, you know, we would have nothing to eat. Like, we would cut up an onion in half and put salt in it and eat it with, you know, a slice of bread that you would steam over a pot of boiling water because we had nothing else to eat, right? So these things did happen. That's largely how I grew up. So poverty touches me in a very personal way. And then the second issue is even more important than that. It's an issue of free speech. America dubs itself as this, you know, the land of the free and all that stuff, right? So the First Amendment is very important. And this idea that somehow you cannot utter certain words on a public sidewalk to people walking by is ridiculous. I mean, this is basically criminalized speech, and I find that completely unacceptable. So it is a very important issue.
Do you have, there's a lot of people out there that are like me that just don't like being approached on the street by panhandlers. And I've got to say that it happens to me on a relatively regular basis. As a matter of fact, when that video was going around of the gal that was walked 11 hours in the streets of New York and was accosted by people, I made the point that I get accosted by people all the time when I'm on the streets. They're not asking me for sex, or they're trying to proposition me or whatever. They're asking me for money. And I could feel just as threatened. So what do you have to say to people who feel that way? Because these laws exist for a reason, right?
Well, the laws exist because this particular law in Xenia exists because if you read the preamble for it, the police have asked for it. This is a law written and passed by the police department. And the reason for that is because they got tired of dealing with poor people on the street. So it's several reasons. The police, they don't like dealing, they feel like probably it's a waste of time dealing with all these panhandlers. And the second issue is largely people that are tired of looking at homeless on the streets, which is both of these reasons are not acceptable to me. And if people approach you on the street, you don't have to talk to them. I travel a lot to Boulder, Colorado. Boulder is a beautiful town, absolutely beautiful, but it's overrun. The downtown is almost overrun by homeless people. And they all ask you for money, but you don't have to say anything to them. You just walk past them and ignore them if you don't feel like talking. Most of these guys are fascinating, so most of the times I actually stop and engage them in a conversation because I like talking to them. So I guess it depends on your personality, but my recommendation is if you don't feel like talking to people, don't answer. Just say no. I don't have any money.
Virgil, Derek J. here. I want to know, if I put on my statist hat for a moment and ask, don't you think it's in the homeless's best interest to be in jail rather than on the street? Don't they get three hots in a cot?
Well, who's paying for that? Who's paying for that jail cell? It's ironic because it's actually a very good question. Those same people that do not want to give money to the homeless or panhandlers, they are the same people that would advocate for their arrest, which would indirectly lead to them paying for their jailing.
Yeah, that's true. And it's not uncommon, by the way, for a homeless person to go ahead and they know the system well enough. They know they can what sort of minor misdemeanor they can commit that's not going to actually result in serious jail time, but might get them enough time to get through the wintertime. It's not uncommon for that to happen where they will want to actually get arrested.
Right. And another issue really is that a lot of those folks on the street, quite a few of them have mental issues.
Yeah.
And the way to deal with mentally ill people is not to call people with guns to deal with them. That's not how mentally ill folks should be treated. So these are some serious problems. And I don't think passing laws banning poverty or panhandling will solve anything.
Yeah, I mean, to me, this isn't about the police not wanting to deal with the homeless. This means the police do want to deal with them, meaning that the police want the excuse to put them into handcuffs. They want to write charges. They want to put them inside the system because they used to do this in Sarasota, Florida, where Mark and I are from. They used to target homeless people with the idea of cleaning up the streets because some of the affluent folks don't like to see the rabble.
Right.
And they would go in and they would tear up camps. They'd tear up people's tents and things like that in homeless camps. And they would do terrible things to try to oust these people, even if they weren't actually bothering anyone. Just the fact that they were homeless was enough of a qualification to be targeted and harassed by the police. So an anti-panhandling ordinance is just yet another violent tool in their belt for that.
It is. And what folks fail to realize, I've had several people telling me, well, why don't they just get a job? Just get a job. Get off the street. Stop begging. Get a job. People don't realize what that statement entails. To get a job, you need to have an address. You need to have an ID. You need to be cleaned up and have a set of clothing to go show up for an interview. Most companies won't even talk to you if you don't have an ID to show up, with a valid address where they can mail you information. There is a lot more to getting a job than just saying, well, get off your lazy bum and get a job. It doesn't work like that.
Virgil, there is a police officer who is in the show chat room who suggests to you that you ask people on the street, do you have a dollar? And that way you put the ball in the police's court to prove whether or not you're asking for money. As opposed to what?
That's a good suggestion.
And so asking, do you have a dollar, instead of asking
it's just
what?
It's just an assessment. Do you have a dollar? Oh, that's interesting. Yes, I do have a dollar. You haven't asked for the dollar, but it's obvious you're asking for the dollar.
Interesting.
So,
good suggestion.
Yeah. All right. So, Virgil, let's continue here with the reenactment. We're almost done with this excerpt here from countercurrentnews.com, where you are acting as the Greene County Herald on Facebook, talking with Officer Paul Harris from Dayton. And, Derek J., you were kind of, I think you just finished reading. You want to reread the threat, the first threat.
I'll see you in Dayton and give you your second M4 arrest. I hope $40 is worth the trip to jail.
Greene County Herald responds, hey, look, a cop threatening a journalist. What a stand-up guy you are, Officer Harris.
Oh, thank you. Remember, breathe easy and don't break the law.
Is that a threat? Is that officer threatening to choke you, Virgil?
Totally. I take that as a threat. That's a direct reference to Eric Garner in New York.
Toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. If you want to stick around, I'd like to talk further about what the plan is here, because you're going to court.
Absolutely.
So there's more coming up here with Virgil Leduva from the Greene County Herald in Ohio. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing. To be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates. 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary. Not a solicitation for legal services.
Are you about to meet the media? If you're about to be interviewed, do their homework for them. Know this about the person who will interview you. He or she is busy, so expect minimal, if any, preparation. He or she doesn't know as much about your topic as you do. He or she isn't as concerned as you are about getting your message out, so you need to take responsibility. Provide a biography and fact sheet, photographs, or other materials that tell your story. Reporters won't be put off if you supply frequently asked questions. Remember, Public Speaking 101, at the end of the speech, what's the one thing you want them to remember? You can download the document I supply to reporters who interview me and squirm through a video that demonstrates how not to conduct your media interview at www.survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We're talking about panhandling civil disobedience. We have the disobedient on the line with us here in question, Virgil Vaduva. We'll continue talking with him about his plans. He's taken the arrest to court. They technically didn't put him in handcuffs, but it's, I guess, technically an arrest.
All tickets are arrests.
So we'll talk a little bit more about that. Your calls and thoughts are certainly welcome. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. We've got Skype as well. Skype username is lrn.fm. And don't forget, if you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, then please support the show by shopping with us. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and you can enter Amazon through the links you'll find there. There's Amazon UK, Amazon Canada, and Amazon US. You just go into the right Amazon for you, and Free Talk Live gets a cut of the purchase. It's that simple. You've got your shopping to do anyway, so you might as well do it through shop.freetalklive.com. Virgil is back with us here from the Greene County Herald. Now, before we talk about going to court on this, Virgil, just looking back to the threats from this officer in Dayton, Ohio, which is not the city of Xenia. That's Xenia is about a fifth the size of Dayton, but yet a Dayton officer named Paul Harris takes the time to call you out and threaten you with arrest on the Greene County Herald Facebook page. He also threatens to choke you because if you don't break the law, he says you'll be able to breathe easily, which suggests that if you do break the law, that he may go ahead and legally choke the life out of you. So this nice gentleman actually doesn't even live in Xenia. He doesn't enforce the Xenia ordinances, but as is pointed out here at countercurrentnews.com, he essentially is threatening to enforce the Xenia ordinances in Dayton if you ever come into the city limits of Dayton. Now, Dayton is a city with about 140,000 people living in it from a quick Google search. Are you surprised that you're well known enough, this Greene County Herald? It seems like a relatively small Facebook kind of internet-based news organization. I mean, how well known are you amongst the ranks of the police in various different cities?
Small. Yeah, that page is small potatoes. It's largely a trolling vehicle for me and a couple of other local activists. I don't pretend to be a hugely circulated newspaper or anything like that. But yeah, that's a good question. Most cops actually know me by name. Not in Dayton necessarily, but ironically, in Dayton, panhandling is actually legal during the day, during daylight. So,
during the day, by the way. We saw some of the videos.
Exactly. So that comment makes absolutely no sense.
Well, don't worry. He'll find a reason to choke you out. I mean, there's always something that they can arrest you for.
You are well known enough, Virgil, though, that your citation already had your address printed on it, as I saw in the video.
That was really creepy. These guys, they came out to me. They never asked me what my name was. Of course, they know me. They probably looked me up in their database, whatever the national or state, criminal database or driver's license database they have. Yeah, they're very creepy.
So they, just to make sure I'm understanding, you're saying, Derek J., they pre-printed this citation, that it wasn't just hand scrawled there at the moment, they typed it up before they came out.
Yeah, it's handwritten. They just walked out, and all my information was already pre-filled out.
I see.
They never asked me what my name is. Just filled out my name, social security number, home address, everything.
Oh yeah, they've got your number. They are your fans.
I'd say that was just a little warning.
Of course.
We'll be driving by whenever we feel like it.
Such a well-known quantity. I mean, congratulations, Virgil. I mean, you're so well-known that the cops in Dayton, which is a 20-minute drive away, at least one of them is well aware of who you are. I imagine that you are the talk of the town to some extent. I mean,
I'm pretty sure that's the case. This article has gotten around in the last few days.
Yeah, and how often does Greene County see civil disobedience? I mean, have you reported on previous acts of disobedience?
Almost never. I mean, if there was any civil disobedience in this area, it's from myself and probably a handful of other people. There's a good group of libertarians around here, but most of them have jobs that take them away from the activities like this. Mm-hmm. My job allows me to do stuff like this a lot more, so I'm thankful for that.
Yeah, I'm sure that the authorities in the region probably just think you're a troublemaker. Why are you doing all this, Virgil?
Right. Yeah, absolutely. Well, I do it because I can and because I care about liberties. And apparently, I don't get this. It takes a guy from Romania to come to the United States to teach Americans about liberty. How does that work?
Well, I'd say it's really common. Nothing really indicts to me the land of the free
and home of the brave.
Quite like somebody who came from Eastern Bloc country, you know, talking with an accent like that that says, "Hey, look, this was what it was like where I was. I saw it happen." It's right. happening to you, and if you continue to stand by and do nothing, you'll get what we got.
Now, is your plan to go to court with an attorney on this?
Oh, no, I don't think so. I think I'll represent myself. At least at the arraignment, I'll be by myself for sure.
Now, with misdemeanor, this is a fourth-degree misdemeanor. Now, that's a different system than we have in New Hampshire. New Hampshire is only Class A and Class B, fourth degree being the lesser of the 4 degrees. However, you are still facing 30 days in jail. And what's the maximum fine on a fourth degree?
I think it's $1,500.
That's $250.
Oh, Derek J says $250.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so it's not too bad. The jail time, I really don't see them trying to put me in jail for this. But
can you get a jury? Can you get a jury on fourth degree misdemeanor?
Yeah,
can?
Any jailable offense will get you a jury trial. Absolutely.
So you're gonna go for jury trial?
Absolutely. Yeah. I doubt they want to do that because we'll probably make the whole thing into a big spectacle. But we'll see what they want.
Can you bring? I know you're a video or like a photo guy. Can you bring a camera into the courtroom there in Xenia?
Yes. Yes, the Supreme Court has ruled, there's a rule 11A that allows for media entities and videographers to bring in video, yes. Camera.
Oh, well, I'll look forward to seeing the footage then from this when it eventually comes out. Did you feel like there was something else you wanted to share about this whole scene?
No, it's just I appreciate you guys covering this. I think it's a pretty important issue, and like I said, it's largely about freedom of speech to me. And interestingly enough, a lot of municipalities, there have been a bunch of court cases, federal court cases, where municipalities have lost lawsuits over loitering and panhandling. Just recently, Fort Lauderdale, Lansing, Michigan, you name it, Portland on the West Coast.
I think the ACLU won a case in all of Florida, and Mark was referring to that earlier. Yeah. I remember we went down there.
Have you looked into it? Is there money involved in this one? Because you're going to put a lot of time and a lot of energy fighting this, and you're going to win because all the case law is with you. The cops will lose nothing. They've got their little law passed.
Right.
It's the city of Xenia or the town of Xenia who's wasting their taxpayers' money, and for which I think everybody involved ought to spend some time in jail. I mean, really, you people are here as stewards to take care of our money, and you're putting it on a losing case. Shame on you. There's nothing you can do about it, but except vote them out later. But the money's already lost. So, what is there? Is there any chance of some kind of settlement on this?
I don't know. I'm in some ways in a secret way. I'm hoping they're not going to drop the charges against me. I have the feeling that they will because they don't want this. They don't want this to happen.
Just a quick recap. You've also been arrested in a recent protest. We had you on to talk about that. You were photographing a kind of a mall sit-in almost, or a die-in, I guess you were calling it. What's the status on that case real quick?
My hearing for that case is on March 3rd, so right before the Liberty Forum, I'm going to show up for court, have our pretrial hearing, and then I'm going to drive to Manchester to hang out with you guys.
Okay.
Awesome.
Very cool. Yeah. Well, we'll look forward to seeing you, Virgil. And folks, where can folks go to visit you with the Green County Herald? What's the best place to go
it's
online?
Greenherald.com, green with an E at the end, greenherald.com.
Perfect.
All the stuff and the videos and recent articles are there.
You're doing great work out there, and thanks for the call tonight. Really appreciate it.
Well, Ian, yes, you have been the example. You and Derek J and Mark and everyone else, you guys have been great examples. Thank you.
Aw, thanks. I appreciate that. And thank you, Virgil, for the
call.
Don't
blame me for this crap, Virgil.
Although, I always worry, right? I mean, I always worry when people are out there and they get it's possible that when you get into civil disobedience and non-cooperation, it kind of catches. Like you get infected by it, and you just want to assert your freedom in as many ways and as many times as possible. But as you found out, Derek J, it can also catch up with you in your victimless crime spree.
Yeah. Watching this video of Virgil openly disobeying the ordinance right in front of the police, it really scared me when I saw him do that and asking for money while they're giving him a citation.
Why were you scared?
Because he was alone. You know, as you pointed out, he had no one around him. It would have been nice, you know, if Mark said it would be harder to do this form of activism with a group of people around you, but it wouldn't be too hard to have someone at a distance recording from with a video camera just to, you know.
Or in a vehicle or something like that, sort of out of the way.
Yeah, and so I just like to know that activists who are courageous enough to openly disobey bad laws have some support nearby.
And it does sound like there is a group, but in that particular instance, they just weren't present. And it can be tempting. Yeah. I mean, when you are of the mindset of doing civil disobedience, it can be tempting to go it alone. But I would recommend that if you catch the bug, then just try to hold off until you can get to New Hampshire and perform it up this way, because then you can have a community get behind you in a way that is just not possible anywhere else. I would recommend you check out the Free State Project at freestateproject.org, and apparently you'll get to meet Virgil if you come to the upcoming Liberty Forum, which will tell you how to get free tickets here in a moment.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, February 16th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.32 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,233 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $233. Antiwar.com reports the Ukrainian ceasefire has held for more than 24 hours now, and while there have been intermittent reports of violations, mostly centering around the contested town of Debaltseve, the situation in general is calm. France and Germany, who were instrumental in the ceasefire, issued a joint statement on the matter, saying local incidents had so far been quickly resolved, and saying the ceasefire was being generally observed by both sides. The OSCE said the ceasefire was substantially implemented in the first 12 hours after the deadline, though they were unable to confirm how it was holding in Debaltseve, which they were unable to enter, and in Luhansk, a key rebel city. Locals in Kramatorsk, one of the towns retaken by the rebels in the days leading up to the ceasefire, reported heavy shelling in the hours before the ceasefire went into effect, but the calm has since returned. That seemed to be the case across much of the nation, with hopes that the ceasefire can lead to a general settlement of the civil war in the weeks and months to come. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports the Israeli cabinet has approved a budget to finance the cost of expected influx of immigrants from Belgium, France, and Ukraine to Israel. The $46 million budget approved on Sunday includes plans to subsidize Hebrew lessons, provide individual assistance and information to immigrants, and to make it easier for them to go through the absorption process. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said during the cabinet meeting, "We are telling our Jewish brothers and sisters that Israel is your home." Netanyahu had previously urged Jews across Europe to return to Israel after the recent attacks on Jewish people in Europe and rising anti-Semitic sentiments. He said, "To the Jews of Europe and to the Jews of the world, I say that Israel is waiting for you with open arms. All Jewish immigrants who move to Israel are entitled to financial benefits under Israeli law." The Israeli Ministry of Immigrant Absorption had a record 6,658 Jewish immigrants from France to Israel last year. Last month, there were almost 2,000 immigrant petitions from France. More than 15,000 are expected to immigrate from France in 2015. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. All of your funds on Coinbase are safe, with approximately 90% of customer funds being stored offline, and all wallets are stored using AES 256 encryption. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. The Guardian reports John Boehner, the Republican Speaker of the House of Representatives, said on Sunday he was willing to let funding for the Department of Homeland Security lapse as part of a Republican push to roll back President Obama's executive action on immigration. Boehner told Fox News, "Senate Democrats are the ones standing in the way. They're the ones jeopardizing funding." Asked if he was prepared to let financing for the department lapse, he said, "Certainly. The House has acted. We've done our job." Boehner also said he did not consult the White House over his invitation to Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu to speak to Congress because the Obama administration might have interfered with that. With the February 27th deadline nearing for funding Homeland Security, more than 40 Senate Democrats have voted three times this month to block consideration of the Homeland Security Appropriations Bill, which has already been approved by the House. House Republicans have written their version of the bill so that it also blocks Obama's action on immigration. Democrats want to fund the department but oppose House amendments that strip funding from executive orders made in 2012 and 2014. Those orders lift the threat of deportation for millions of undocumented immigrants. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The push to legalize marijuana is gaining momentum. These prescription doobies will do a whole lot more than just give patients a case of the munchies.
Proponents are piping up to say that medical marijuana can help patients with some of the chronic illnesses that have been majorly killing their buzz. Unfortunately, 36 U.S. states are still not a kind bud of the legalization argument. But in states that do have the plan, the results have been, well, pretty far out, man. Patients nationwide are bluntly asking state legislatures to finally mellow out so that they and their doctors can work jointly to stop the suffering that's making a hash of their lives.
So it's clearly an issue that means a lot to these patients.
So states shouldn't toke their time with this policy. We'd be upset if patients had to wait a long time.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free to bring up whatever you'd like at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online at freetalklive.com.
Derek J. says, don't stay in school. If we get the chance, I think we should talk about that because your article has stirred up some controversy, as you might have expected. Our toll-free number here tonight, of course, 855-450-FREE. Ian, Derek J. and Mark all in the studio here tonight. And don't forget to visit Derek on his website, derekj.me. Derek, what will folks find there?
Oh, well, you'll find a copy of this letter and the follow-up from... you know, what happens when you suggest to family members that they drop out of school? It was not very pretty. Sometimes your parents get upset. Sometimes...
Your parents saw the article?
Oh, yeah. They were very upset.
All right. Yeah, I definitely want to talk about that. So, DerekJ.me. You can get more of Derek J. in written form, in video form, and also audio form, because you are the host of several different shows. But more recently, you've relaunched one of my favorites, Flaming Freedom.
Yeah, I don't know how much I can talk about it on these airwaves, but it's a show that focuses around gay sex.
Well, that's not all, but, you know, it's not something
that you're... No, that's pretty much it. Now that I've taken over the show, that's what it's about.
It seemed to loosen up a little bit in its second week as far as the topics that y'all covered, but you are not afraid to go into the details of sexuality, which I think is very interesting.
That's right. I find it to be liberating. It's a part of humanity that we all share, and we can't really talk much about. So
I'd
like to do that.
On Flaming Freedom. So go and get it over at DerekJ.me. As we continue here, we'll take your calls about anything you want. Derek, I know you wanted to talk about a guy who is in prison who somehow was able to post to Facebook. Now, I don't know how you managed to do this from inside prison unless you... are being smuggled an illegal smartphone, perhaps, in the prison cell, or you are asking someone on the other end of an email or a phone call to actually update a Facebook feed for you. So what happened here, Derek?
Well, let's find
out.
He's
in trouble.
Yep. Kate Nibbs reports at Gizmodo.com. Headline, prisoner got 37 years in solitary for Facebook posts. In South Carolina's prisons, an inmate who secretly writes Facebook posts about missing his family can be punished the same way as one who rapes a cellmate. Hundreds of inmates...
I don't think raping a cellmate is going to get you 37 years in solitary. Speaking as the only person here who's been in prison, state prison, I think that's how... It's outrageous, the idea of 37 years. What would happen in a Florida state prison is that if you raped a cellmate and you got somehow caught at this, and it's not like that happens too often, then you would be taken to the county jail. You'd be charged and for sexual battery. Mm-hmm. You'd probably get something like 8, I'm just guessing 5 to 10 additional years. You got to remember, it's difficult for people to feel too bad about convicts getting raped. And so they, you know, give you 5 to 10 extra years or something like that. And you wouldn't spend any time in confinement necessarily. It's just another charge with additional time.
Hmm. So instead, this is an administrative decision by the jail to punish this individual.
No jury, no judge, no nothing.
Right.
I've had these situations. I had one disciplinary report while I was in prison. I did have it overturned, but I had I was found guilty of something that I clearly explained to these people I didn't do and couldn't have done. Like they were clear on that. It was obvious to them. They're just like, you did something, so we're going to charge you with this. So there's no doubt that this this is a messed up system.
Well, the reality is, Mark, that hundreds of inmates are being handed down indefensibly harsh punishments for using social media, including one man, Taheem Henry, who was sentenced to over 37 years in solitary confinement for writing 38 Facebook posts.
Wow.
In addition...
37 years for 38 posts. Doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, you would think it would be 38, but yeah. I don't know. I don't get it. In addition to almost four decades of solitary confinement, Henry lost 74 years of canteen...
Oh, man.
...phone...
What?
And visiting privileges.
Visiting privileges? I thought that was... I didn't even think they could take that away from you.
His case is extreme, but he's not the only one. The Electronic Frontier Foundation discovered over 400 cases over the past 3 years where inmates were disciplined for using social media as level one violations, the same as rioting, homicide, hostage taking, and a host of much more violent and serious transgressions.
It just doesn't make any sense. I mean, I'm bewildered by this, given that, you know, Derek J., you and I have not gone to prison as Mark has done, but we did go to jail. We went to the Keene Spiritual Retreat, as we like to call it here, the county jail in Cheshire County, New Hampshire. And you and I both blogged from jail. Facebook posts are generally fairly short, but we were writing hundreds and hundreds of words in blog posts every few days or week or whatever. And the jail certainly knew it. I mean, they were well aware that some of the guards would actually comment on the blog posts. So that, for us, was no issue whatsoever. I just don't even understand what is the violation they're alleging here. You're not allowed to speak to someone, to give a message to someone, to give another message to outside of the jail?
Well, it's not illegal here, Ian, but the Electronic Frontier Foundation looked into the reasoning behind these long sentences. What they discovered, the sentences are so long because the South Carolina D.C., and I imagine that's the Disciplinary Corrections or something.
Department of Corrections.
Yeah, okay. Right. Issued a separate level one violation for each day that an inmate accesses a social network. An inmate who posts 5 status updates over 5 days would receive 5 separate level one violations, while an inmate who posted 100 updates in 1 day would only receive 1. Makes a lot of sense, right?
No.
In other words, if a South Carolina inmate caused a riot, took 3 hostages, murdered them, stole their clothes, and then escaped, he would still wind up with fewer level one offenses than an inmate who updated Facebook every day for 2 weeks.
God. I'm sorry to laugh. It's just so absurd and
it's
so
absurd.
Outrageously
this is
ridiculous.
What's happening to a man's life.
Yeah, I mean, and what say does he have about it? It's an administrative decision. They've just decided that, well, you get no privileges. You're going to solitary. You don't get access to visitors. You don't get, the book cart. I mean, they're taking away everything he could possibly have to tie him to humankind, which is, of course, torture. I mean, they're literally torturing this man because he posted to Facebook. I mean, I think it's important to really focus on what this is.
Yeah.
When you take away a human being from other human beings' contact, that's what solitary confinement is all about. They will mostly go crazy.
Yep, there's study after study after study. You don't have to cut people's fingers off or make them chew tinfoil or shove bamboo shoots underneath their fingernails or, drip acid in their eyes to torture them. You can torture people mentally, and one of the easiest ways to do that is to keep them in confinement. Another way is to deprive sleep. These are all torture methods. I'll admit, I would rather be deprived of sleep for 3 days than have my finger cut off or something like that. Sure, I'm not claiming that there's not lesser and greater forms of torture, but the simple fact is it's all torture.
More from the story here. In Henry's case, a right-wing blog called Charleston Thug Life had pointed out his Facebook posts prior to his punishment.
So someone snitched him out, is what you're saying. This blog.
Not entirely clear on that. I guess that is the case. Yeah, perhaps the pressure to crack down on Henry's illicit posts contributed to his nearly 4-decade isolation punishment. After documenting Henry's habit of illegally posting to Facebook, Charleston Thug Life posted an update celebrating how South Carolina prison system now takes the blog's recommendations of who to investigate.
This sounds like the equivalent of Stop Free Keene, a local group of busybodies who relishes in the extra punishment of the people they consider to be bad folks. Now, what was this guy in jail for originally? I might have missed that detail. Did you share that?
I have not discovered the original sentence or punishment.
Does it really matter?
No, it really doesn't matter. I mean, look, it would be one thing if he were using Facebook to threaten people. Like, if he were in his jail cell.
To coordinate an escape or something that.
Yeah.
He beat a man to death.
Well, not a good guy, but people change over time, and he should be able to communicate with folks.
I don't think he's not a good guy. I don't think that particularly matters. This is your prison system that represents you putting a man in solitary confinement for 37 years.
It doesn't
for Facebook
represent
pay.
Me. I don't do
well,
that.
Well, that's what they're claiming.
855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number here tonight. There's more coming up on Free Talk Live. Share your thoughts.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges. This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms.
I get it.
You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30%, while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should, too. Find out what they know. Call us, and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Free Talk Live.
I'm a supporter of law enforcement, and my boyfriend's a police officer.
What if there was a law passed that made cigarettes illegal? Would you also support your boyfriend going and raiding people's homes and businesses because they had some black market cigarettes?
Enforce laws if people are smoking cigarettes and they're not supposed to be?
Mm. Yeah.
Would he enforce them?
Yes.
Yes, he would.
Right, that's the problem.
It's his job. Can I go to a more extreme example then, Lindsay? What if it was like Nazi Germany in 1939 and Jews were illegal? Would your boyfriend go around and grab them and throw them into concentration camps because it was the law?
If it was his job,
my
he would do it.
God.
Wow.
I'm not saying it's not a personal issue. It is personal.
Doing something wrong is doing something wrong, whether you've got the law on your side or not, ma'am.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. I love my Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free to bring up anything you want here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Derek J's advice to his little sisters is don't stay in school. Apparently, your parents weren't so happy about that, Derek J.
But it's great advice.
Well, we'll get into that here in a little bit. 855-450-FREE is the number. And don't forget, you can join us online at freetalklive.com.
Yeah, don't forget that you can get your cryptocurrencies at expresscoin.com. It's the best choice, whether you're getting Bitcoin or Litecoin or Dogecoin. They have a couple of other options over there. Whatever your cryptocurrency of choice might be, you can get it at expresscoin.com. They make it fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. The fees are really quite low. They're a licensed money services business. You can use a check or money order. Just go to expresscoin.com and get started there. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, you can even do it from your smartphone by downloading the app at expresscoin.com. Make sure you use the coupon code FTL. And if you get less than $40 of the cryptocurrency of your choice, you pay no fee at all. So it's less than $40 with coupon code FTL at expresscoin.com.
All right, so our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You bring up anything. Chris Kringle is on the line calling from the North Pole. Chris Kringle, a.k.a. Pete
hey,
in California. Hello, Pete.
This is Chris Kringle.
I mean Chris Kringle. Go ahead.
I think I'm going to reach through the phone and punch. Oh, can't say that. That's not appropriate. But look, anyway, I have a comment about that guy in prison on Facebook.
Yeah.
You know, thank God for a few people that are in there that aren't afraid to be activist. But, you know, I think that it's ridiculous that they gave him so many extra years. And, you know, I think that there should be a wake-up call to law enforcement and government people, because the more evil things they do to people that are nonsensical, you know, the more bullets are going to be flying back at them when people have nothing to lose. Within 3 days of the trucks not showing up to bring food to fast food, or the water turning off, or the grid, or whatever the calamity might be, they're dead. You know, and you know what? What are they going to do when their pay source is cut? Are they going to still be prison guards and say, "Oh, we're
well,
doing
if they're
it
prison
for the
guards."
Better
I, I was in prison. I came up with a scenario.
They're dead.
If the society collapses, the prison guard is going to go through and shoot all the inmates before they go elsewhere. I mean, those aren't the – you don't want that competition out there looking for food sources and that sort of thing. But
not necessarily. Supposedly they'll gas level 3 and 4 yards and stuff. But you know what? The people
–
you know, they'll
gas level 3 and 4 yards?
I was at a level 3 prison.
Yeah, I was in a level 2. But you know what happened? If stuff hits the fan, then yeah, level 3 and 4 yards are going to kill with gas. But that's assuming that the people aren't going to, you know, rise up and kill them and raid the army. Of course they are.
Well,
you have nothing to
so
lose.
So this is
stuff.
Your I think violent this, fantasy.
There's some small amount of truth to what you're saying, which is that when people feel they have no choice, they will
they
resort
to
violence. Right. When they have nothing to lose, they will resort to violence. I don't know about this whole the world's going to end thing. People
it's
have been
end.
It, well. All right. They've been predicting it for a long time.
Let me be honest.
Okay.
Let me give you a practical scenario.
Okay.
How is it that our CIA and a few Mujahideen warriors were able to destroy the Soviet Union over there in Kazakhstan and Afghanistan? I know we economically paper-cutted them to death, but don't tell me that that's a coincidence. They believed it was an honor to die for Allah, and their family was getting murdered by the Russians, so they armed themselves and locked and loaded and said, enough. When you have a people, especially as selfish as the people in the United States, when you take away their convenience, don't tell me that the sheeple aren't going to, for the sake of self-preservation, going to go off. And that means the government
I'm not
is
claiming that
meat.
One way or the other. I just don't see their conveniences being taken away.
They didn't, by the way, in Hurricane Katrina, I'd like to remind you that conveniences were taken away in the area of New Orleans and the surrounding parishes that area. They did not have conveniences at all, in fact, and it was an evacuation zone, and yet people still stayed there, and they cowered, and they turned over their guns when the police came to take them from them. So
I
don't think
– That's a very good point.
Yeah. I think it's just your violent fantasy. Pete or Chris, I think it's just your violent fantasy that you want to put out on the airwaves in the hopes that somebody else will do your dirty work for you.
Not at all. Here's my quote. My quote to end this is this, you know, it's the slogan for my magazine that I tried to Kickstarter called Militant Magazine. I'm going to put it on like Crowdfunder or GoFundMe now. But the slogan for our magazine called Militant Magazine is either you're for us or against us.
Yeah, good luck there, Chris Kringle, getting anybody to pay. Thanks for the call. Getting anybody to pay for a dying genre of media. Let's put money into a violent advocating magazine. Maybe there is money out there for that, but
I don't know.
Not going to get it from me because I don't support violence as a solution to things.
I concur that when people feel like they have no choices, when there's nothing left, that they will likely resort to violence. We've seen stories like that time and again of people going in and like shooting the city council and that sort of thing.
Yeah, that's true.
These things happen.
It hasn't done anything to end the state.
Right. The rest of it just sounds like ramblings. I don't know. Where is this? What is this collapse going to look like? I know a lot of people believe and want to prepare for it and that sort of thing. And I think it's a good idea to be prepared for emergencies. There's no doubt about it. But
well, in Venezuela, there are people waiting around blocks to get into stores.
That much is true.
Could look like that.
Yeah, the government could certainly try to implement price controls. But you'd think that you would, like, if you were going to spend time preparing to get away from some trouble, you could just, you know, have enough money to leave the country if that's what you needed to do. If those sort of things happen in the United States,
maybe they'll lock down the border.
But I mean, there's 4,000, 5,000 miles of border in the United States. There's a lot of border to lock down. Are you telling me you don't think you could get across the border? Let's not talk about the coast, mind you.
Yeah.
You don't think you could get across the border in New Hampshire?
I think you probably could.
They don't have enough people to line across the border.
Yeah.
And if it was really that bad, you shoot them and eat them.
Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I just I don't buy into the whole violence fantasy stuff that Kris Kringle likes to call about here on Free Talk Live. And
he's from a metropolitan area, correct?
California, somewhere, yeah, in there.
Yeah, so, I mean, it's more likely that collapse would be more disastrous in a metropolitan area than it is here. I know
That's true.
When I lived in Philly, I could look out my window and pretty much picture the whole city bombed and people running in the streets and saying, you know,
that's a horrible vision.
Me imagining, you know, where do I have to run? How do I hide? Where do I bring food?
Where can
I have
you,
a bug out bag? Yeah. And how do you escape? Are the bridges closed? You know, and so those sorts of questions, I think, are more common for people in metropolitan areas. When I moved to New Hampshire, it was like, oh, things will be all right. I don't know how to get around. And, you know, I can't imagine they could close too much of the woods that I could escape through. So, you know, there's it's just a difference of perspective, I think.
I can understand where folks like Pete/Kris Kringle are coming from, because I used to believe that violence was what it was going to have to come to. I used to prepare for that kind of thing. That's what I believed in. And then I moved to New Hampshire and I changed my perspective on that because I was able to actually connect, I think, with the police here as human beings than rather than just these anonymous, mindless automatons, which it's easy to forget the humanity of the police when there's so many stories of them treating people inhumanely. Being able to actually connect with people who work for the police, I think, has helped me see the see that violence isn't necessarily the only solution. That we can achieve a better society through peaceful means.
And do we really have to get freedom through total economic collapse?
There's more coming up here in moments. 855-450-FREE. Yeah, I'd like to get it because it's a good idea. It's Free Talk Live.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Are you hungry for delicious, nutritious, rich, and satisfying home-cooked meals? Discover the Vita Clay 4-in-1 Smart Organic Cooker. Unglazed Zeesha Clay, an ancient secret that makes this fast multi-cooker so special. Infusing your food with incredible flavors, perfect texture, vitamins, and minerals for your good health. It's a slow cooker, rice cooker, a steamer, plus a yogurt maker. Go to VitaClayChef.com and enter promo code RADIO20 for 20% off checkout. That's VitaClayChef.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek Jay's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Who did you let down today? Your wife? Your kids? Well, how about yourself? Take a look in the mirror. If you're tired of your drug and alcohol problem, you need to fix the problem and right now, before you hurt or kill yourself, or worse yet, somebody else. Call the addiction specialist now at the Detox and Treatment Helpline, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you have private insurance, we specialize in finding you the right treatment. When you call right now, you'll speak to a recovering addict who understands what you're going through right now. Let us help you break your addiction to drug and alcohol before it's too late. This call is completely confidential and free. So if you have private insurance, take 5 minutes of your time. Call right now. I promise it'll change your life. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. Call right now. 800-208-5187.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free to bring up what you want at 855-450-FREE. We've been talking about a man who has been sentenced to 37 years in solitary confinement. Now, he was already in prison, but he's now gotten 37 years to be alone in prison because he posted some updates to Facebook, which were benign. They were just updates about I love and miss my family, that kind of stuff. Nothing threatening. I mean, it wasn't like he'd threatened somebody from inside the jail cell and used Facebook to do that. That, I think, would be one thing. But in this case, he was just, you know, posting friendly updates, and some local busybody watchdog group took notice of it, and they sent some sort of notice out via their website and brought the attention of the government bureaucrats to it, and now this guy's in trouble. You can share your thoughts with us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Coming up, the New Hampshire Liberty Forum. We will be broadcasting live from the event, as we have done every single year from the Liberty Forum. It's a lot of fun always to meet Free Talk Live listeners and hang out in the hotel, which is going to be a brand new hotel this year for the Liberty Forum. Used to be in Nashua. Now it's going to be Manchester, which means it's going to be even easier for you to fly in, because Manchester is where the airport is. So you just fly into the airport, go straight to the hotel, and you're there at the convention, which will likely bring hundreds of people together over the weekend who all love the ideas of freedom, and they'll watch great guest speakers and panel discussions. Free Talk Live will broadcast live there. Flaming Freedom will also be broadcasting live there on Thursday night. And so it's going to be a lot of fun. You can go to nhlibertyforum.com to learn more about the event. But here's how you get a free ticket to the event. You, first of all, have to meet the qualifications. One, you have to not be a Free State Project signer. So you have to have not yet signed up for the Free State Project. And you can also not live in New Hampshire already. So you have to live outside of New Hampshire and not yet be a Free State Project participant to get this offer. If you meet those qualifications and you're willing to pledge to go to one of the various different, you know, the panel discussions, speeches, gatherings,
you have to commit to go to one of them, and the one you have to commit to is the one on Saturday at 12:30, which is the FSP questions session, where Carla Mora, one of the early super activists, movers here as part of the Free State Project, will field any question that you have. You don't have to ask a question. You just have to attend the session. If you've got a question, feel free to ask it. She'll field questions about the Free State Project, answer some objections, and if you agree to go to that, just email me at ian@freetalklive.com, and then I will use your email to secure you a free basic ticket to the Liberty Forum. So go to nhlibertyforum.com to learn more about the event, and if you're ready to make that commitment just to attend that session, I'll get you a free ticket. So email me at ian@freetalklive.com if you want to take advantage. Make sense?
Yeah, what a deal.
Yeah, it's an amazing
deal. It is a great deal.
So anyway, toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. James is in Jacksonville, Florida with Ian, Derek, Jay, and Mark. Hello, James.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, James.
Your last caller makes all of us look bad. I mean,
why does he make you look bad?
No, I'm just saying, you know, if you don't agree with the system, they automatically try to, you know, say that you want a violent overthrow or something like that.
I see what you're saying. I mean, just to be clear, the guy who was calling in is not a libertarian in any way, shape, or form, from what I can tell. And so, to me, he doesn't make me look bad because I'm not in that camp. I'm not in the camp of the people who advocate for violence. There are people within the liberty movement who do understand the ideas of freedom, who also think that violence is the solution. At least with them, I can have some empathy because I can relate to them better. But, yeah, that guy, I don't feel like he reflects on me at all. Especially when I'm here to answer him.
No, and when it does, you know, if it does happen, like he was saying, the cops are the ones that are most awake. The cops in the military are awake to what's going on. So, you know, when it does go down, they're going to be trying to protect their families and all that. So,
yeah, they're also armed and trained, you know.
Exactly. The reason I was calling, I heard the thing about the dude in prison and all that, and it just made me think about in Florida. I found this out recently that a lot of prisons in Florida and throughout the country are privately owned, and they have actual mandates through the state to keep it full. And a lot of the people that are in prison are in there for nonviolent crimes, such as selling drugs and stuff. I just wonder if they're just throwing the book at people that are already about to do a term and no one's really going to pay attention.
Well, just to be clear, the guy who we're talking about did not get 37 extra years in prison. He only received 37 of his remaining years that he has to spend in a solitary confinement unit, which I'm not saying that is a good thing or anything like that, but he's not staying for an extra 37 years. It's just going to be 37 years of absolute hell.
It's crazy.
Right, and whether or not the place is run by a private company seems irrelevant to me. I mean, either way, whether it's a private company or a government-run prison, they all want more prisoners to be in their prison because whether it's a government bureaucrat in charge or not, more prisoners means more funding, period.
Yeah, when it comes to most places that have private prisons have also the public, government prisons, and they do have agreements with the private prisons that they'll keep them at a certain capacity and that they'll give them a certain amount of money per convict and all that stuff. All those things are absolutely true. Also, if you look historically at prisons, you'll find, that in the U.S., especially in the South, when harvest season would come around, that the judges would start increasing incarceration.
So they could go out and get slave labor?
So people could do prison, the prison farm could have, more people to do the harvest, and then, their sentences would be relatively short and that sort of thing. So these things absolutely happen. They rounded up people to do that kind of work. But at this point, I think with the real... the real problem comes down to the government has figured out that they can essentially hold us all, the taxpayers, hostage by having these people in prison. You don't want the bad people to get out. We got to build more prisons. And so they built more and more and more prisons. The prison population it's incredible the jump from the early 80s till now. And it doesn't seem like there's any way to turn it around.
Yeah, I don't have a problem with a private-owned prison. I have a problem with a mandate with them working with the government, just like everything else. You know, it's like them working hand-in-hand together to take out the little guy, which obviously in this case is the prisoner. You know, it's just ridiculous. Like Rick Scott, he came out a couple years ago saying that it should be a felony to get caught with a weed pipe twice.
That's what happened. That happened in Florida. Just an FYI.
Well, I'm in Florida.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Thanks for the call tonight, James. I'm with you there. I appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREEZE, referring to a recent law that I think came out last year in Florida where if you get caught with a some sort of, not just weed pipe, but any kind of paraphernalia, drug paraphernalia, you get caught with drug paraphernalia more than once, and it becomes a felony. So the first time it's a misdemeanor, the second time it is a felony in Florida.
Yeah, well, we used to say in jail, there's a little saying, Florida, come on vacation, leave on probation.
They say that about a lot of places.
Return though. On extradition.
So, toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. I don't know, Derek J., was there more to say about this poor guy who is now going to be sitting in a solitary confinement for 37 years? Did we pretty much cover that?
Yeah, I think we've pretty much got it, just that it's super bad that this is happening. The UN considers it to be torture, so why is the U.S. doing this? It's a matter of course for hundreds of other prisoners. He's not hurting anyone by posting to Facebook.
Right. Now, would you feel differently if he had posted a threat? If he had done something that was somehow
threatening? What kind of threat are you going to make from jail? Oh, I'm going to get him.
Well, you could say, I will get you when I get out or something like that.
Yeah, when I'm 85. No, I'm not going to take that seriously. You got to look at these things on a case-by-case basis.
Well, and I'd say...
To be real, like, no, a threat from jail is not a threat at all.
So in the West, specifically California, prison gangs have real power, even extending onto the streets. Mm-hmm. I don't know. None of this makes any sense. I'm
but
only
then
watching...
prosecute when it happens on the
Agreed.
Streets.
Absolutely. Oh, I think this is ridiculous. The idea of Facebook posts, it's nonsensical. If somebody would have posted... If, for instance, Ian, I maintained your Facebook account while you were in jail and it was a problem, and then over the phone you'd say, hey, I'd like to say this, and I'd say, type in, Ian says, mm-hmm. quote, you know, this, and then, unquote, is that a problem?
Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Coming up, should you stay in school? Derek J. says, no way. We'll tell you about it on the way. You can take control of the airwaves here on Free Talk Live at 855-450-FREE.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
Hi, this is Larry Smith. Sometimes bad things happen to good people, like when the jeweler ruined my ring and wouldn't do anything about it. But when my Legal Shield attorney called him and told him what my rights were, I received a check for over $2,100. Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com, or call 855-340-SAVE. Again, 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement, and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website, fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper, FPP News, at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free to join us here at 855-450-FREE. Coming up, should you drop out of school? Derek J. says yes. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE if you want to comment on that. Also, we've got Skype. You can Skype in at username lrn.fm. Mark, our tickets, they're booked.
That's right. We're going to the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference in downtown Austin. Yeah. What's that?
It's official. It's a done deal.
It's a done deal. There's no doubt about it. It's at the Moody Theater on March the 28th and 29th. There's also a little get-together on the 27th for those that arrive early enough.
Okay.
Keynote speakers include the world-famous investor, economist, and author George Gilder. Also, IBM's architect of the blockchain technology, Adept Sambala Nair. He'll be flying in from India. David Johnston, Jason King, Robert Murphy. I'm excited to see Robert Murphy again. Vitalik Buterin also. Charlie Shrim and many other speakers. They're still getting lined up. This is the biggest Bitcoin event going. I think it's the most important, too, because of the $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. This is an event where they give away $1 million to people who have different ideas as far as what to create in the Bitcoin space. And it's fantastic to watch those guys doing their hackathon stuff. You know, they're up all night. TexasBitcoinConference.com to get your tickets. If you use coupon code FTL, you get $25 off the $150 admission, making it $125. $25 of that $125 that's left goes to Sean's Outpost to help the homeless. It's really a great price. It's an amazing price to get for this one-of-a-kind event. And just go to TexasBitcoinConference.com. We were there last year. I'm excited to be there again. And I want to thank them so much. TexasBitcoinConference.com. Coupon code FTL.
Before we get into Derek J's story about staying in or dropping out of school, I've got a related piece from a website called AnarChant.com called The Truth About College. And Derek, you went to college, right?
For a little bit.
Yeah. I think that's true for all of us.
Ethan Glover writes, this summer I'll be looking for a job in New Hampshire so I can drop out of college. I only have a year left, but I have yet to get anything valuable out of attending. My knowledge and skills are beyond what I need to get started in the industry I want to get started in. To be frank, I'm wasting time in school.
That's right. I'm glad he recognizes it.
He says, a sort of review of the movie Big Hero 6 can illustrate my issues with universities. It's a movie that happens to lie to children about the value of college. It lies about the kind of people that attend, and especially about the value of the professors who teach. Although Fred isn't a student in the movie, he's the representation of 95% of all college students.
The idea that college students are working on world-changing products is ridiculous. Labs aren't full of things like zero-resistance bicycles and nurse robots. They're full of old, used, donated, half-broken, and obsolete equipment.
I think there are some labs where some of that stuff is going on, but not enough of it to sort of make it important in that way. I also... So when I say drop out of, if I wouldn't give the advice to drop out of school unless you
shame
have
on
a,
you, Mark.
Unless you have a plan. Now, if you've got a plan, school's a great place for people who have no idea what they want to do.
I don't agree with that at all. If you don't have a plan, you shouldn't be in school. There are so many people. I mean, I tend to agree that school's a waste of time, with a few exceptions.
I'm just still talking about high school, the free stuff.
I'm talking about elementary school.
Well, this article is about college specifically.
Yes.
So, Mark, I'm sorry. I thought your comments were about college.
I don't think you should pay to waste time. You can waste time anywhere. As a matter of fact, you could get a job and get paid to waste time. But, yeah.
You could take the money that you spend on the college paying to waste time and actually take that money and start your own business, or maybe make a down payment on a house to get yourself a leg up in the regular semi-free world instead of the world of academia. Anyway, going on here, he says they're full of a bunch of junk equipment, basically, these labs. And he says if you want to work on this kind of a project in a university, you're going to have to be well beyond in-class studies. Your knowledge will have to expand far beyond what anyone will ever teach you in a public classroom. To get in on such projects, you have to be self-taught. No one is going to help you get to that level. Professors don't act this way either. In 3 years, I've only had one teacher that bothers to put in the work to create his own homework and lectures. He's the only one that doesn't put me to sleep, and he's capable of making complex subjects easy, which is the definition of teaching, he says. For everyone else, I see nothing but laziness. My current linear algebra professor passes out 3 worksheets per day. These worksheets are the kind of fill-in-the-blank things you might be familiar with from middle school, where you just go through the book and copy down the keywords that fit into the sentences. You remember doing that crap?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
God, that was awful.
Well, I mean, school's full of
busy work.
Full of busy work.
Yeah.
And this is my wife and I, we do what we call family-directed learning. But it's a form of sort of unschooling. And
for your son Jack, who is almost 7 years old,
He'll be 7 in March. And what the idea is, and I think that this is so important, is that you don't remember the things you don't want to remember. Just think about it for a second.
Absolutely.
Think back to school and think about the things that you've learned. You learned the things that you were interested in learning, and what we try to do is we find the things that, because children love learning. The only kids that don't like learning are the ones that have gone to school long enough to be like, school.
And nothing kills the drive to learn more than school.
Yeah, school does. Now, think about this for a second, because really, I know this could be difficult for people to internalize. What school does is it disenfranchises you from the learning process. You say, now you are the only one who can teach you anything. We've established that, and I believe, in my, at least to my mind. So therefore, what it does is it turns learning over to a teacher and says, you're responsible. You say you're responsible for your learning, but then you turn it over to a teacher, and it makes no sense. You walk away, you get a piece of paper. In many cases, MIT gives away its entire coursework for free.
Yep.
If college was worth it, you would go to MIT and you would learn all their stuff for free. Now, why? And many universities allow you to what they call audit a class. You could sit through a class for free. Why is it that we pay for, at that point, it's very, very clear that a college is giving, you know, $100,000 for a piece of paper.
That's right.
And it's obvious. Our education system's so messed up. We need to do something. And everybody just says, somebody else will take care of it.
What are you going to do about it?
Well, I'm going to take my kid out of it.
Well, that's all you can do. As far as doing something to change this gargantuan established system, that doesn't seem very likely.
No, that's what it looks like. That's the change. Taking personal responsibility where you can.
He says the only purpose for these things is to keep the class busy. There are no lectures to speak of. You show up, fill in a worksheet, and take the test.
Nice, huh?
This is something that anyone could do themselves from home by purchasing a textbook, or better yet, logging into Khan Academy. My professor for Android programming and operating systems has a habit of putting tutorials from websites on the projector. One of his favorites for Android is Vogella. Our current homework assignment, he puts quotes around that, is to work through this tutorial, which he then links to on Vogella.com. Apparently it's publicly available. So this professor that you're paying, apparently $900, he says anyone who would pay $900 for this class is an idiot. So you're giving this school $900 to sit in a class where the professor sends you to a publicly available website and has you do one of their assignments as the homework assignment.
If you want to learn something about anything, you can find out more by doing it on the internet. This is like... college is this old technology that hasn't caught up with the internet. You remember when people used to pay a ridiculous sum of money for encyclopedias? And then out came that the encyclopedia that was going to be on the computer. I can't remember what the name of it.
Encyclopedia Britannica?
Yeah, Britannica was the first one. There was
Encarta,
one.
Encarta, Microsoft.
Encarta.
Oh, yeah,
that's
was
it.
The one.
That was what. Thank you, Ian. I feel so delighted that somebody thought of this old thing.
Yeah.
It was such a big deal. Now, look, and you paid a lot of money for Encarta, but it was a lot cheaper than the Encyclopedia Britannica.
The books. Yeah,
right. Books and paper and stuff like that. And how long did that last? 5 hot years before something on the internet basically replaced
it. Wikipedia destroyed.
Yeah. Wikipedia destroyed all this stuff. Now Wikipedia is bigger and more complete than any encyclopedia we ever had.
Yeah.
And it's changed the world. These colleges, I'm sorry, you don't need them.
Well, the funny thing about your statement is it's partially incorrect about colleges being behind the ball on the internet. It was actually colleges who helped launch the internet back when the internet was in its incipient stage.
It's their job to teach people.
It was a link between colleges, primarily, is what the internet was. Colleges, for the longest time, have had some of the best internet connections available. They're very, very fast on many college campuses, and there are classes being taught there that are likely teaching some valuable information. But what you're saying, Mark, is that none of the information they're teaching is inaccessible in other ways. That they are being outcompeted by the different venues on the internet for gathering information, and that all they really hold on to is this prestige. They've got the diploma and the Ivy Halls and the sororities and the fraternities.
All just a bunch of stories.
We'll come back with more here on what this guy says is the truth about at least his experience with college. And then your thoughts are welcome as well. 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
When the leading antihistamine and Nasacort go nose to nose, Nasacort wins, stopping more of the chemical responses that can cause your nasal allergy symptoms. And when you stop more causes, you get 24-hour relief from sneezing, an itchy runny nose, even congestion. It's prescription strength medicine available over the counter. Nasacort allergy 24-hour. Stops more of what makes you miserable. Use as directed.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
The 3 most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, 1, share 1 episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Monday, February 16th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,231, up $3. Silver opened at $17.31, down 2 cents, and Bitcoin is trading around $236. Today's metal prices brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. How much food is in your pantry right now? Could you feed your family for 2 weeks, 1 week? How about even 3 days without any help? Keeping an emergency food storage kit is the most effective way to begin to ensure your family's well-being during an emergency. eFoods Direct is food security for whatever the future holds. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, on Sunday, the Federal Aviation Administration outlined a proposal for regulations for commercial operators of unmanned aerial vehicles or drones. The proposal includes passing a knowledge test from the FAA, no nighttime flights, keeping drones within sight of the operator, and a security check by the Transportation Safety Administration. The FAA also attempted to satisfy critics who feared the drones could be used to invade privacy and violate civil liberties. The agency proposed a review of privacy and civil rights protections before deploying the technology, as well as requiring that all personal information collected be destroyed after 180 days. A federal judge has ruled in favor of the NSA in a lawsuit related to the agency's internet data collection with AT&T. The Electronic Frontier Foundation attempted to argue that the NSA's surveillance was unconstitutional. However, U.S. District Judge Jeffrey White claimed the plaintiff was unable to prove they were specifically being targeted for surveillance and thus could not sue. The case stems from revelations by former AT&T technician and whistleblower Mark Klein, who exposed the company for secretly working with the NSA to collect internet traffic from customers. The Liberty Beat is brought to you by Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Support also comes from CoinArch, offering innovative online trading solutions for Bitcoin. Visit CoinArch.com and sign up using coupon code MAX and get free brokerage for the first 7 days. It only takes $10 to start an account. That's CoinArch.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Monday, February 16th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. U.S. Senator James Inhofe has apologized after he used photos from 2008 to promote the idea that Russian troops are invading Ukraine. Speaking on the Senate floor, the Oklahoma Republican presented exclusive photographs he said were evidence of Russian troops and tanks crossing into eastern Ukraine. However, the Washington Beacon and other websites quickly proved the photos were of Russian troops driving near Russia's border with Georgia in 2008. Inhofe released a statement saying he was furious to learn one of the photos provided now appears to be falsified from an AP photo taken in 2008. The senator stated there was still plenty of evidence indicating Russia is advancing into Ukraine with tanks. He has been a vocal supporter of arming Ukraine to fight against Russia. As of last week, 11 members of Congress have co-sponsored a resolution calling for the declassification of 28 pages of the 2002 Congressional 9/11 report. The resolution was introduced by North Carolina Republican Representative Walter Jones. Two varieties of genetically engineered apple have been approved by the U.S. Department of Agriculture. The USDA's Animal and Plant Health Inspection Service approved Onagonkan Specialty Fruits genetically engineered apples designed to resist bruising and browning after being sliced. APHIS said the tree does not pose an agricultural or environmental threat. The agency approved Onagonkan's Arctic Golden and Arctic Granny apples. The Liberty Beat is sponsored in part by the Free State Project. Want to find liberty in your lifetime? Then join thousands of others who are making the move to New Hampshire, the freest state in the Union. To learn more or to pledge to move today, visit freestateproject.org. Support also comes from the Conscious Resistance Network. Videos, news reports, and articles from a spiritual anarchist perspective. Experience the Conscious Resistance at theconsciousresistance.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Monday, February 16th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Last month, the FDA approved Hallucex, a new class of weight loss drug that helps users avoid overeating by producing nightmarish hallucinations whenever food is around. Hallucex targets the brain's cerebral cortex, stimulating the centers responsible for fear and visual processing.
Test subjects reported an unprecedented decrease in appetite and showed dramatic weight loss, with only 18% reporting night terrors or subsequent cardiac arrest.
It's designed to make fatty and sugary foods even scarier. An apple just looks like it has fangs, but a milkshake will threaten you and your family by name.
Earlier incarnations of the drug proved to be too powerful and produced mental states in which test subjects no longer believed that food had ever existed. An unshakable belief that the subject had to eat all of the food on the planet in order to prevent food from rising up and destroying the human race.
No, you don't understand. I have to do this.
Or the conviction that food could be negotiated with diplomatically.
With the Lab Report, I'm Aisha Patel.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You are invited to join us toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about the school systems, specifically the college one at this point. But Derek Jay is going to answer the question, should you drop out of school at any level? Coming up here in a moment, Ian, Derek Jay, and Mark are in the studio here tonight, and you can join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. But to get the conversation started here, I'm reading from an article at anarchant.com called The Truth About College, written by Ethan Glover. He says he's looking for a job in New Hampshire so he can drop out of college. He says he only has a year left, but he's yet to get anything valuable out of attending. That's a pretty serious statement. After having spent who knows how much money, I'm going to hope he's got a scholarship or something like that, but after spending 3 years in college to make a statement that you got nothing out of it,
yeah,
that's a pretty severe indictment there of that system. And he's going over just some of the laziness on the part of these teachers, pointing out that one of his Android programming and operating systems teacher has a habit of putting tutorials from websites up on the projector. His homework assignment is to go through a tutorial which anybody can go through online anytime over at a site called Vogella.com. He says anyone who would pay $900 for this class is an idiot. Going on with his story here, he says when there are no online tutorials available, this teacher likes to download PowerPoints from the internet. When he gives a coding assignment in C that utilizes Unix system calls, the class has to teach themselves and each other the code. In the movie Big Hero 6, the professor tells the main character, Hero, that his program isn't easy. He was implying that it would be challenging, but Hero would learn a lot. Well, college isn't always easy, but it's not because of the difficulty of the material or how much you need to learn. The difficulty comes in when you have to waste your day in a lecture, only to have to go home and then teach yourself the subject matter. Or it can be hard to keep up with many useless subjects at once that have nothing to do with your career goals, which is something we covered recently. I mean, that was my experience in college, was 90% of the course load that I took over the two-year associate's degree I took were essentially retreads of what I'd learned in high school in English and algebra and, you know, history class, and it was a total waste.
And then once you think about what you learned in high school, I mean, I'm still waiting for the day I'm using algebra. Now, I'm not saying you shouldn't learn.
Yeah, it doesn't
happen. I'm not saying you shouldn't learn algebra. I'm just saying that, you know, there's a lot of stuff in high school that maybe I would have been better off just working full time in taking a GED. Honestly, the difference. Somebody needs to explain to me the difference in this. There in Florida, there's the Florida Academic Scholarships. Ian, you probably got that.
Yeah, that's what I think paid for my college.
Yeah. So there's that program, which basically will give you some money towards, I think it's the first 2 years or something like that. I'm not here as an advocate of the Florida Academic Scholarship Program. But there's that track. And if you're not on that track, explain to me what the value of a high school diploma is over a GED.
What's the value of a GED?
Well, I mean, you
help you get jobs.
Does it?
I don't think it does, because I've
who's
never been asked for it.
Who's ever been asked to see a high school diploma during a job interview?
I don't know.
But
usually it's just a question, right? Like, did you graduate high school? And on your,
you think you just lie and get away with it?
I don't think that lying is a good idea. But all that said, well, no one's ever checked on that.
At that point, what is high school? And you know, you just say, "Yes, I graduated." Like, you can go online and graduate from high school tonight. Somebody will say, "Yes, here's your high school diploma." Don't worry, you can graduate from high school this evening. But the really, when it comes down to it, just about anybody who's going to go out and get a job can pass the GED, right?
I would think so.
I mean, if you can't read, you're not qualified to have left, right? So if you can't read and you're trying to quit school and you're 16 years old and you're taking GED, you should be able to read by 16 years old.
For sure.
That's a failing of the government school system already. 19%, as according to an article written by the Huffington Post, and this number's all over the place on the internet, 19% of government school graduates, it's really important you understand this, graduates are functionally illiterate. When you're talking about one out of every five students can't read, you could replicate that with no school system at all. I mean, how come we're paying $14,000 a student for one out of five of them not to be able to read?
I heard it was up to $20,000.
I heard it actually used to be a lot better about 100 years ago or 200 years ago
before the
public school system, where there was something like a 95% literacy rate.
There's no challenge, says Ethan over at anarchant.com, because there are only lazy teachers that expect students to know the material because of some irrelevant PowerPoints they've read from. They collect a paycheck paid for in large part by tax dollars for no work at all. Dale is listening in Tennessee via TuneIn. Hello, Dale.
Hey, how's it going? Hey, Mark, I've got the thing that you said about you've not come across a situation where you've used algebra. You've used the concept that you learned in algebra, but maybe not the math itself.
Okay.
Because you're the kind of individual that you can take the things that you do know to figure out the one component that's not there.
Yeah, but you could do that with logic puzzles.
Well, that's pretty much it. That's one thing that the math skills bring out in you. And believe me, I was not a good math student. Still, am not a good math student. But I see how that flows out. I mean, it's a concept. It's just like it teaches you to think logically. You're talking about these education. I've been taking. I know they're cheesy, but I've been taking these, whatever they call them, MOOCs, MOCs, or whatever, for about the last year. So
this isn't cheesy about that. This is what we're talking about here.
What's a MOOC?
It's a massive – go ahead.
Online – it's a massive online education thing.
Yeah, it's basically a giant class online.
I took one. The first one I took last year was I took one on creativity that I didn't last too long. But, you know, one of the things they had me doing was like eating orange with a peel on it for creativity. Yeah, I didn't stay in that one too long. But I took English because I needed to brush up on my English skills and understand why the written language, you know, does like this and does like that, because I have to do a lot of writing in my current job. And it's helped me tremendously.
Well, I don't doubt what you're saying, Dale, that taking algebra can help people think outside of a certain box and help them visualize.
That's how college does. I mean, they're paying for that experience that they get in 4 years, what the rest of us get in 12, 8, 20 years over a longer period of time.
I disagree, Dale.
It's a waste of time, in my opinion.
The way you're doing your education is you're opting into it. You're choosing the things you want to learn, right? But in college, it's totally different. They hand you down. These are your requirements. You have to take these certain classes, even if it has nothing to do with your schooling. Like, for example, I had to take volleyball in college. What was the point of that?
There's no point in that. Those are the bad cards that are dealt on the table, you know?
Well, yeah, but you don't want to waste your time playing with bad cards when you could be, spending your time on the things you love.
That's the difference between high school and college, though. I'm paying these mamma jammas to deal me bad cards, and I refuse to do it, Dale.
Thanks, Dale. I appreciate hearing from you, man.
I do not blame you for that at all, because the cost, I mean, the reason it costs so much, I mean, they're paying their athletic departments tens and twenties of millions of dollars, you know?
Well, that's one reason, but also the professors are very tenured and they get quite a bit of money and, you know, guaranteed raises.
It's not even that great for professors anymore. Most of them are not getting tenured. They're associate professors and they're just working for a paycheck and they can get fired at any time.
Who's getting the money? The administrators?
Building these giant campuses.
Well, you know, the thing I think about teachers is I think the education system, the way it's set up, is just horrible. I think every teacher out there, well, not every teacher out there, but the ones that were really good or whatever, they should be like entrepreneurs and not work for any system at all. If you're a good enough teacher, you can sell your skills.
That's true. People will seek you out if you are a good teacher. Thank you for the call tonight. You know, like somebody who might teach guitar to your kids or something like that. Word gets around. If the guitar teacher is good, the parents are going to tell other parents and they're going to get other business.
It's called a MOOC, by the way.
Spell that.
M-O-O-C.
M-O-O-C.
Massive Open Online Class, a MOOC.
Interesting. Open as in no cost to attend?
I think it depends on, I would say that there's a lot of those.
We'll come back with more here, and your thoughts are welcome on dropping out of the system, the college school system, and other schools. We'll come back with more on Free Talk Live.
I walk my dog every day.
We walk every morning.
And I've got the best-looking dog in the neighborhood named Stanley. He's a collie mix.
Teddy is a rescue dog. He's a lab.
We meet the same people every day.
People comment about what a beautiful black coat he has.
They'll tell me, oh, he's so soft and he's so silky.
There's a difference when I compare Teddy to the other dogs.
And these dogs that have the brittle hair, it's coarse. It doesn't lay nice. It's not shiny. It's dull. I tell them about Dynavite.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
I've told them this is what I use.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
And it really made his coat shiny.
You know, it didn't take very long. They've got their nice, expensive jogging suit on, and their dog has their smooth, beautiful, soft, shiny coat. So now their dog looks just as good as they do.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw for enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial in toll free. Share your experience with schools. We're talking about colleges at the moment, and Derek J is going to suggest that anybody should drop out of school at any age here in a moment. We've got the story from anarchant.com, and it is Ethan who's writing it. Ethan Glover saying he is getting ready to find a job in New Hampshire so he can leave college. After having been in college for 3 years, he's determined it's been a total waste of his time and money. Lazy teachers, outdated, decrepit kind of lab conditions. It's just been an embarrassing experience for him so far.
I would say that there are some careers you have to have a degree for. For instance, you're not going to get a job as a lawyer unless you go through law school, right? And to go through law school, you have to get the prerequisite degree.
Or unless in New Hampshire we're able to repeal the requirement that means you have to be a lawyer to represent someone in court. If we could actually get rid of that pesky requirement, then anybody could represent.
You probably need a lawyer
person
to get that done.
No, you would need state representatives to do
that. Yeah, and I'm just saying that what you're talking about is some fantasy future. I remember when we moved here, you were talking about maybe they'll put a big dome over the state so that the snow won't fall on anymore. So now I don't want to talk about Ian's fantasy world. What I'm saying is,
it's not unbelievable to believe that could happen, Mark. We're here in New Hampshire.
The dome?
Not the dome. Well, who knows what the future will hold, but
I'm so glad he owned it. He owned it, right? They're going to destroy the skiing industry in New Hampshire with a big dome.
No one's skiing down the main street in Keene, New Hampshire. It's not unreasonable to believe that the requirement that you be an attorney could be repealed someday in New Hampshire. We already have a situation in New Hampshire, and this is apparently fairly unusual, where an average person who is not an attorney can absolutely be hired to represent somebody who is, not an attorney. So, Derek J., if you went to court and you're fairly good at taking care of yourself in court, but if you wanted to hire Mark or me or somebody else to handle the representation for you in court as an attorney might, you could do that. And, I don't know if it's legal to hire that person. I presume it is. I haven't heard it's illegal, but you can definitely have someone else represent you in court. The only thing is that in New Hampshire, there's a rule that says you can only do it twice per year, meaning that the person who is the representer, the person sort of acting in an attorney's stead, that person is restricted to doing that thing twice per year. So that's obviously not enough times to make a career out of doing something like that. But it is to some extent a shot at the Bar Association that they don't have a total monopoly on representing people in court here in New Hampshire. So I'm just talking about expanding that.
There are careers where I believe you need a degree in order to do those careers. Being a lawyer is among them. Being a doctor, if you want to be an allopathic doctor, you're going to need to have a degree. If you want to be a college professor, if you want to be an engineer, yeah, you can probably do it with the correspondence courses much more cheaply. But my uncle's an engineer, and he's hired guys with the ITT degree and that sort of thing. So there's some careers that you're going to need it for, but there's a lot that it's just basically you're saying, look, I've done been to college.
Yeah.
And that's really,
I've got a communications degree.
It's pretty lame when it comes down to it. You haven't shown the stick-to-itiveness to finish college as much as you've shown the gullibility to pay the bill.
Going on with Ethan's piece here, he says, to further inflate the value of universities to get accepted into school, Hero has to impress the faculty at a robotics competition. I believe the idea is he's aiming for a scholarship. In reality, schools accept scholarships almost at random. I don't know about you, but in high school, they taught me to go to the spammy fast web and fill out as many scholarship applications as possible. Doing so, by the way, will fill your inbox with advertisements from every business that might target college students imaginable. If you write a lot on each application, I guarantee you'll get enough to pay for at least a year or two of tuition. The quality and content of your writing doesn't matter at all. Most of the time, your GPA, experience, and credentials don't matter one bit. From there, all you have to do is use the forms on FAFSA, and the government will pay for the rest. Scholarships, for the most part, come from universities themselves. All students use them and federal and state grants to pay for the cost of tuition, and these things are stolen directly from taxpayers. The whole process only helps to increase the cost of college and inflate the egos of professors who think they're doing something good. Even after they steal all this money from other people for their useless education, most students still have to take a loan out to get by. If they want to pay for expensive university housing and food plans, a minimum wage job on campus or off could never pay for it all. Welcome to supply and demand, where stolen tax dollars make up most of the demand. He says, here's the truth. Single individuals' school projects do not build the kinds of technological inventions seen in the movie Big Hero 6. Large teams with years of experience create them over time, experience that has turned their college degrees into useless conversation starters hung on the wall. That's if they ever got one. I'm not saying I'm trying to invent something that would change the world by leaving college. Rather, I'm only trying to illustrate how overestimated the value of college is. That value is decreasing as employers realize that self-taught individuals do better work than those with degrees do. I only want to work in an industry that I love and do my part. I'm tired of wasting my time in college courses that have nothing to do with my goals and in courses taught by lazy professors who have never learned how to teach. And I have to agree with him. If I were to be hiring someone to do some sort of radio thing, I would much sooner hire someone who's spent 4 years working in a radio station than 4 years sitting in various different, mostly unrelated college classes. It's a no-brainer for me. I want the person with the experience,
yep,
with the skill. And you don't learn that in a classroom.
Well, I think that in many cases, you can, whatever it is that you want to do, and this is really the challenge, is many people go to college because they don't know what they want
to
do.
That's true. That's a huge reason to not go to college, by the way, I think. You should not go to college unless you know you want to be an engineer, doctor, or something that absolutely, positively requires one of these college degrees.
So you go and work for the company that, you know, whatever it is that you want to do, you'll be better off working for a company that you do that stuff, you know, whatever it is, and then you'll get this leg up. You'll be earning money rather than spending it at the same time. You'll learn more in a day than you do in a week in college.
Yep, makes sense.
My point is that college robs you of those opportunities because you're spending the time on those frivolous classes, like I mentioned, the required classes like volleyball. Instead,
you could be building yourself.
I can't be building myself because I'm spending time doing these other things. So it's an opportunity cost that people just don't look at.
It's huge cost. It's more
comfortable to believe the lie that our parents and the government and everyone else tells us that you need college in order to succeed. And if you don't have it, you're just going to end up homeless somewhere.
Well, and there's so many different stories of people who have gone to college and then they've dropped out. And they've been major successes. I mean, Bill Gates, he dropped out of college.
Well, there's a lot of examples of it. And I think that, you know, it could be difficult. A lot of times you need that degree to sort of as a pass through for other people who have the same sort of Stockholm syndrome piled up behind them.
Well,
right?
That's true. If you're looking to get a job at some kind of business where the people who are in charge of hiring also went to college, in some cases, they will give preference to people who've been to college.
There's the government
sort of
world,
an in-crowd thing.
Right. I think that there's the sort of the regular world, there's the government world, and there's the corporate world. In the government world, degrees are absolutely necessary to move up because they've got all kinds of value placed in that. But they don't pay very well. They do have pretty good benefits, assuming that the organization sticks around. The corporate world often wants it, but you can work around it if you try. In the regular world, they don't care that much.
855 450 free, but should kids drop out of younger schools? We'll find out coming up.
Hey there, Guns80.com continues to surprise us with low prices and high-quality Ghost AR-15 rifle kits. At Guns80.com, Ghost AR-15 kits are an even better idea than buying at gun shows or through private parties, because the Ghost AR-15 kits at Guns80.com require no background checks, no registration, They don't even have serial numbers. That's what I call privacy. Go to Guns80.com to order your Ghost AR-15 rifle kit. No dealers, no hassles, ship direct. Guns80.com or 844-2-GUNS-80. That's 844-248-6780.
We love that you're passionate about GCN. And whether you're a listener, a business owner, or a radio industry professional, we've redesigned the new GCN newsletter to keep you in the know. Get updates on your favorite GCN shows and hosts. Go to GCNlive.com and click on the banner in the upper left corner. Just for signing up, you're automatically entered for monthly giveaways. Start receiving your newsletter today. The future of talk radio. GCN.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special super early bird price of just $40 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $40 price only lasts through early March, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Overburdened with material comforts, America's wealthy can expect another disappointing holiday this year. As Brian Scott tells us, the rich will simply be buying too many things to experience the true meaning of Christmas.
All across the country, those at the top of the economic ladder are denied a privilege that the poorest of the poor take for granted. Rather than fall victim to the rampant consumerism that seems to increase each year, the poor find meaningful joy in simple Christmas traditions, like singing carols to keep warm and hugging relatives who have not yet died. At stores like these, the spiritually bereft must scramble for popular holiday toys in a vain attempt to duplicate the Christmastime happiness that the impoverished enjoy.
Poor people are grateful for just a roof over their heads or something to eat. My wife and I are both lawyers, so that's not enough for us. Certainly hope poor people don't take what they don't have for granted.
This is the Onion News Network.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You are invited here to take control of these airwaves. Toll-free numbers, 855-450-FREE. You don't have to talk about education. You can bring up anything you want, although that is the topic on the table here so far this hour. We read a story about called The Truth About College, about one young man and his disappointing experience having spent 3 years of his life, and he says it was pretty much all a waste. He's ready to drop out. Derek J. says you should drop out of elementary school while you're at it, if you are still there. We'll get his perspective on things here in a moment. And with you in the studio tonight, you do have me, Ian.
Derek J.
And Mark.
And also, don't forget that we're doing a special giveaway of AMP only shirts that are only for Free Talk Live Platinum amplifiers. The shirt giveaway will commence in a couple months from now, but you need to be signed up as a Free Talk Live amplifier platinum level by March 1st to qualify for this cool shirt. It's a long sleeve shirt on a tech/wicking fabric. So this is the higher quality fabrics. This isn't just some cheap cotton shirt. It's a very nice quality shirt, and it's a kind of a word cloud design, which has words excerpted from our show
description. Long sleeves?
I did mention that it was long sleeve. Designed by one of our existing platinum amplifiers, Michael January. He's the guy who's really spearheading this. He's picked the shirt, picked the design, and we said, yes, that looks great, because it does. And he's excited about it. We're excited about the opportunity to offer it to you. Of course, the AMP program is a way to get behind Free Talk Live and help support the show, help us get into more ears via new radio stations, new internet listeners, and you get perks too, like access to the AMP-only call-in lines, the AMP-only podcast forum, the AMP-only Facebook group. It's all there at amp.freetalklive.com. Get signed up. If you want to take advantage of this free shirt offer, then you need to be a platinum amplifier by March 1st, and you need to stay a platinum amplifier through at least May 1st. And once you do that, you'll be qualified, and you'll get a free shirt.
Yep, so, that's how he designed the thing, and I think it's great.
It's very generous of him. And again, you can still be a gold or a silver amplifier, and you still get all the regular AMP perks as well. So you get perks. You help us out. Really appreciate it. Please go to amp.freetalklive.com. Let's go to Patricia. She's listening in Albuquerque to Kiva. Hello, Patricia. You're on the air. Hello, Patricia. I heard somebody there, but
and
she dropped
it.
Off the line. Let's try Adam instead in Bridgewater, Massachusetts, listening via LRN.FM. Hello, Adam.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, you're on the air.
I just wanted to comment on something that Mark was saying earlier, how the government sector and the corporate sector both view having a degree differently. And
sure.
It reminded me of something back when I was in the military. I served in the Imperial Navy for 6 years, and it was interesting. You would actually get promoted faster if you had a degree, regardless of what subject the degree was, if any.
Yeah.
I mean, if you were like a torpedo man on a submarine, then you had a communications degree or basket weaving degree, you would actually get promoted faster than your peers, regardless of like, you know, your evaluations and whatnot.
Yeah. It's just about the class. Yeah, the governments love degrees, and that's a reality.
Well, yeah, I mean, they want to propagate their system, so of course.
It's not entirely their system, though. I mean,
it's a state-run education system, Keene State University. There's a lot of state in these universities, isn't there?
Yeah, I think that it's just that the sort of – I think it's a more of a mentality than anything, but, you know, you could be right.
Adam, anything else you want to share?
I'm currently in college right now, and I understand it's a big waste of time. It took me, you know, I'm in my last year, and I've totally looked back on it. And I mean, it's just you learn a bunch of obscure facts that don't really have to deal with anything unless you're specializing in a specific field. And I mean, I have a lot of headhunters calling me up asking me, like, when I've graduated, and they don't even care what degree I'm going for because they just want me for my experience in the job that I did back in the Imperial Navy. But I know one day when I have kids and they say they want to go to college, I'm going to tell them to go become plumbers or electricians and then save up money if they really want to go.
Hey, why don't you answer those callers by saying I'm dropping out now and going to work for you?
Well, I mean, I'm in the situation right now where I have so much of my family. They're like, you know, pushing me to finish it up, and there's so much expectation behind it.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, honestly, I get to go for free because of the GI Bill. And so I'm just kind of enjoying the rest of my 20s that the military stole from me since I joined right out of high school. So I'm just kind of trying to enjoy myself. But
well,
I
hope you're partying a lot.
Oh, I am. Trust me.
There's a lot of that goes on in college, that's for sure.
It's about the only thing worth anything.
Thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Yeah, you could go to the college parties here in Keene and not actually go to the college if you
want
to.
Yeah, but he's saying if he's not paying for it and he's really only doing it to make his family happy, well, then party a lot.
Yeah, that's true.
You're not doing it for the money and you're not getting anything out of it. Yeah.
It's tough, though. There are a lot of familial pressures that go into people going to college. That's probably one of the strongest ones. I mean, obviously, when you're going to the government schools, they pressure you in that they always have these college nights where they want everybody to go and talk to these recruiters, and they're constantly pimping the idea of college throughout middle and high school. But really, the biggest pressure has to be the fact that family members expect this, and people don't want to let their family down.
Yeah, well, when are you going to live for you? You know, if
Good
you're
question.
In college, think about that. Are you doing this for you or because your family wants you to?
You know, I'll I'll put up money for Jack to go to college if that's what he wants to do, but I'll match him maybe 2-1, 3-1, or 4-1, whatever it is, depending on where he wants to go and what he wants to do. Mm-hmm. He's got to have skin in the game. He's, you know, if you want to go to school and you've earned the scholarships, fine. If, you know, whatever it is and you're paying for it, that's fine. If you want the parent to pay for it, if you want me to pay for it, I'm willing to help you out. And I understand college is expensive. The government's creating a bubble in it or whatever. But you've got to have skin in the game. You've got to put it on the line. And I'm not interested in your loans, son. Anybody will give you a loan and indenture you for the rest of your life. You better have the money.
Cash. Pay cash.
Yeah. To do it. Otherwise, you won't be getting it from me.
You know, my parents actually, at some point, from what I understand, they got fed up with my sister not having skin in the game as far as college. She went to a four-year school, got whatever the hell degree in whatever art or nonsense she ended up getting.
Finger paints.
And then she ended up wanting to go back to school to go and get a culinary degree after that. So essentially flushing the entire 4 years of college that she had gone to. And my parents at that point were not willing to foot the bill for her, and she had to figure out a way to do it on her own. But
that's because college is like a time for putting your life on pause. You're like, oh, I can live in this fake bubble world,
yeah.
And the only thing I have to focus on are grades and learning this information
and
making marks and, of course, the parties. Yeah, but you don't have to ground yourself in any kind of reality or produce value for others.
And there's so many of these junk degrees out there that these poor kids, they graduate and they feel like they've accomplished something, and then surprise, you can't get a job at anything besides being a waiter, and you know your degree is worthless. So what do you got to show for it? Toll free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. But Derek J, you've gone even further than this last article. You're saying drop out of school, period, not
yes.
just college.
Any get school. Out of there.
My Little Sisters, this is your blog from DerekJ.me, also featured on FreeKeen.com, entitled, what is it? Don't Stay in School by Derek J. My Little Sisters are in seventh grade. They're good students. They work hard, they lead group projects, and they spend hours each night on homework. Tonight, I sent them an email encouraging them to drop out. I wish someone had done this for me. Both of my parents worked in government schools as teachers and administrators while I grew up. I was told to work hard and that it would pay off one day. That was a lie. I don't think my parents meant to lie to me, but the reality is I don't think they ever considered what they were saying. They were just regurgitating what is popular. Stay in school. Success in school leads to success in life. Both of them had done okay, so why wouldn't I believe them? I don't think my parents meant... Oh, you're taking a quote. Sorry about that. Quite out of context there. The problem is that neither of my parents knows what would have become of them if they hadn't gone to school. We can't know what could have been because that opportunity is lost. The fact is, both of them lead mediocre lives. They have bouts of excitement when on vacation, but work for them always seemed draining, not uplifting. Both of my parents are workaholics, and I mistook this dedication to their work as interest rather than avoidance. They were avoiding much of the unpleasantness of life by burying themselves in their jobs. They didn't have to. Both of them had cozy, tenured positions and could be as lazy and incompetent as the other teachers around them. What could have become of my father if he had become a pro wrestler or taught on-the-job carpentry lessons? We'll continue with Derek's piece here in moments, and we'll find out what his parents thought.
They say life is about choices. So let me introduce you to one of the best choices you can make in life. Grainger Choice. The Grainger Choice product line has just about everything we need to keep this place running. From batteries to V-belts, safety to sump pumps. And with Grainger Choice, we can trust that every product is dependable and cost-effective. When it comes to making life choices, here's a great one. Grainger Choice. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgrainger.com/choice or stop by. Grainger. For the ones who get it done.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another micro-loan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Hi, this is Steve Sanchez, and based on a recent study, it was found that 57 million Americans had legal issues over the last 12 months, but only 60% of those studied sought out the services of a lawyer. Why? In a nutshell, affordability. Well, my friends at Legal Shield have created a solution that can help you not if, but when you need an attorney. For as little as $17 per month, Legal Shield will provide you unlimited access to qualified attorneys at an accomplished law firm for advice and counsel on legal issues, no matter how serious or trivial. For over 40 years and with 1.4 million families across North America, Legal Shield can help you, the loyal GCN listener. Representatives are standing by now to answer your questions, so call them now at 1-855-340-SAVE. That's 1-855-340-7283, or visit them at lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com.
Results will vary from case to case.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Moments remain here. Enough time for you if you would like to share your experience with us. Jarek J saying, drop out of school. Is he right? Is this advice he should be giving his sisters who are apparently in seventh grade?
It's pretty radical advice.
Send an email off to them giving them this advice. We'll continue that here in a moment. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You can, of course, visit us online over at freetalklive.com. And don't forget to check out Derek's website at derekj.me. I will continue his article from derekj.me and freekeen.com here in a moment. But first, let's go to Mark calling from Texarkana. You're on Free Talk Live, Mark.
Yeah, hey, how are you doing?
Welcome,
I just
sir.
It's Martin, actually. I just wanted to say Martin. That that college and the whole educational industrial complex is set up. It is a fraud. And they have dumbed down everything so much that, you know, there was a time when somebody actually graduated from high school and you actually look at high school tests that were 100 years old. Let me tell you something. You had what's even better than what's a college education today. If you read some of the college
tests. Yeah,
we've
seen some of those high school tests from back in the 1800s, and they were pretty challenging.
The ones to graduate grammar school were pretty impressive.
And even though he's a despicable president, and I can't stand him. But, you know, we put up the icon of Abraham Lincoln. And Abraham Lincoln never went to college. Abraham Lincoln never went to law school. But Abraham Lincoln was a very successful lawyer. And going to law school is BS. And law school could all be, as a matter of fact, in California has online law schools. They have 20 schools, law schools that are not accredited by the American Bar Association, but it is accepted in California, and they're online law schools.
Can you take the bar exam without having gone to a law school?
Yeah, in California you can.
But in other states?
No.
In California, you go to a law school, but it's an online law school. Mm-hmm. It's a non-accredited law school. There's it used to be there were very few states. The last state, I think, was Montana, where you didn't even have to go to school. All you had to do was apprentice. As a matter of fact, excuse me, Virginia still has law school where it's called reading the law, where you apprentice in a law firm. You do not have to go to law school in Virginia. You can do an apprenticeship in Virginia. Law school is not required. Hmm.
Mark, thanks for your call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Derek, you say your parents lead mediocre lives, and you go on to suggest that maybe had they not gone to college or school, maybe they would have been able to do things they truly loved. You say, what if, what could have become of my mother if she finally opened the private schoolhouse of which she always dreamed? I'm afraid neither of my parents aimed high enough or thought enough of their abilities to try for their dreams. When I looked at the way my parents' lives turned out, I decided I wasn't going to be like them. I was going to follow my dreams. If I failed, at least I would know I tried. Michelangelo said, quote, "The danger for many of us is not that we aim too high and fail, but that we aim too low and achieve our mark." Since deciding to follow this path, I've produced a feature-length movie sold on Amazon and Walmart. I've hosted not one but two nationally syndicated radio shows, and I've gone to jail fighting for my freedoms, all before reaching the quarter-century mark. I've amassed a bigger bank account than both my doctor's sister and scientist brother, who are 8 and 10 years my elder, respectively. They both hold multiple degrees, and I don't hold one. I'm now embarking on a new business venture, Cop Block Protection, which you can go to copblock.org to learn more about that, which will one day serve millions of happy customers by providing a peaceful remedy for the problem of rampant police abuse. And none of this would be possible if I'd fallen in line and followed the course laid out for me. Stay in school, work like a dog, obey authority, and die without impacting the world in any significant way. My little sisters deserve to hear my honest advice. Drop out and follow your passions. Life, especially youth, is too short to waste following the dreams of others. The sooner you start to listen to the tiny voice inside you, the sooner you'll start living. Don't wait until you're old and retired to start. Start now. Now, you wrote a lot of these ideas in an email to your sisters. You actually include that later on in the story, but we don't have time to read the actual email. I think we got the gist of what you were communicating to them. And apparently, they showed your parents.
Yeah. So the way this played out is I didn't get a response from my little sisters, either of them. Haven't contacted me since sending this email. And we were pretty close. I mean, on a basis where if I emailed in the afternoon, they would respond in the evening. And I haven't heard from them since. I've sent them packages in the mail and still haven't heard. So, you know, this upset them. According to my dad, I got a response email that evening, and he said, "Dear Derek, I know you went through a difficult time in high school, and I'm glad to hear that you're now very successful, both vocationally and financially. I don't think you realize how much you upset Liz," that's one of my younger sisters, "with the message about quitting school. School is tough enough for young people, and while you're entitled to your opinion, those two are my wife and my responsibility for the next 6 years at least. We hold your brother, sister, and in-laws to be very positive role models. Please do not send them any more stuff like today's message until they are much older.
Right.
Love, Dad."
Once you've done the school. And I get it. I mean, I understand where he's coming from. This is a radical piece of advice. But I think that it's fair to give everybody in the family should have their opinion, right? And, like, let's lay it on the line here. If you're going to go into debt educating somebody, or if that person's going to go into debt, they deserve to hear the other side of it.
I'm saying they should drop out now. They're 12 years old. My little sister, I got her a drawing pad for Christmas so she can draw. She wants to be an artist, and she's told me this for years. She wants to be an animator. Is she going to learn that in elementary school, Mark?
Probably not.
No, they're going to waste her time, and she's brilliant. She plays piano, she sings, she's in the choir, she's active
in her
church.
What's she going to do during the time that she would be in school?
She'll be drawing.
She draws anyway. She said animator draws.
Yeah, so but why should she have to deal with the pressures of hours of homework after school when she could be playing with her friends and creating her own webcomic? She could have her own business starting at age 13. She could be hired by Marvel Comics at 16.
Her friends will be in school, so she won't be playing with her friends.
Maybe they'll drop out too.
That's okay. That and the dome over Keene, New Hampshire. Please.
And she's got
grown folks talk here.
She's got churchy friends, right? So a lot of them do homeschooling and stuff. So she would be able to play with them.
I think homeschooling might be a really good choice for her. That way she can concentrate on things. But I remember being in, I just think high school is just this big waste of time. And she's actually younger than this.
She's in seventh grade. Yeah.
I remember being the, I was the teacher's aide for the math teacher. And he,
you brown noser.
He just asked me to do it. I didn't know any better. I was grading the consumer math students' papers. Now, I'm in ninth grade. I'm in algebra, or is this pre-algebra? I don't remember. Pre-algebra was eighth grade. So
consumer math is like math for dummies, right?
Yes. Yeah. And this is addition and subtraction stuff that I was doing in sixth grade. I couldn't believe that people were doing this
in
stuff.
High school.
Yeah. I mean, it's just a filler waste of time kind of thing. You might as well challenge yourself while you're there if you're going to be doing it.
Well, I don't see what's wrong with what Derek is saying here. I mean, Mark, you balked at it, but then you also agreed that homeschooling would be a better, it would be an improvement.
I just think it's a radical proposal. That's all. It's tough for people to internalize radical proposals, man. That's it.
Let's go to my Matt. He's in Jersey City. Matt, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hi. First of all, I want to apologize for my impediment. I have some gauze in my mouth because I got my wisdom teeth out.
We never would have known. Had you not told us, you sound fine.
And I happen to agree with Derek J. I think that getting out of the compulsory education system in America is a wonderful idea. Read the book Dumbing Us Down by John Taylor Gatto. He's the reason I wanted to drop out. Well, actually, and I want to mention something. You should probably start calling it rising up as opposed to dropping out.
Ooh, I like that. Yeah, language is important.
And that was all I wanted to mention about
I like
the
that.
School
yeah.
thing.
Yeah. Thanks for that. Yeah, you're right. The words you use will be the ones that define you. And I thank you for the call, Matt. Appreciate hearing from you tonight. Rise up out of the school system.
John Taylor Gatto is a great one. I directed my dad towards the School Sucks
project. Oh, you
wrote
him back?
Yeah, I did write him back a quite lengthy response and just included, you know, my points about, hey, how Liz is an amazing artist. If she started now, think of where she could be in 4 years. Mm-hmm. You know, this is a waste of time for her. The things she values, she's not learning in school. And by the way, you know, you're retired. Now, you would have the time to spend with her to self-educate, to do some homeschooling. And look at what school was originally intended to do. Produce citizens who go off and die in wars.
And obediently pay taxes if they're not going to go die in the war to just go along with the system. And that, of course, is one of the things that they teach you very effectively in these government school systems. Folks, you can go and check out more of Derek J's writings and media creations on his website, derekj.me. And, of course, you can join us tomorrow night because we're here 7 nights a week doing Free Talk Live. Meantime, we'll be over at freetalklive.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
6 drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Hey! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nestle Toll House Refrigerated Cookie Dough. Who would you bake some love for? Find fun and easy baking ideas at tollhouse.com. Kids love doing arts and crafts projects, especially when you join in. Try channeling all that artistic energy into the kitchen and bake up some creative treats together. Think of your art supplies as the frosting, sprinkles, and decorating gels, and use cookies or cupcakes as your canvas. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
The latest episode of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Monday, February 16th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,231, up $3. Silver opened at $17.31, down 2 cents, and Bitcoin is trading around $236. Today's metal prices brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. How much food is in your pantry right now? Could you feed your family for 2 weeks, 1 week, how about even 3 days without any help? Keeping an emergency food storage kit is the most effective way to begin to ensure your family's well-being during an emergency. eFoods Direct is food security for whatever the future holds. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, on Sunday, the Federal Aviation Administration outlined a proposal for regulations for commercial operators of unmanned aerial vehicles or drones. The proposal includes passing a knowledge test from the FAA, no nighttime flights,